Are you guys ready for some Street Fighter?
Yo, Jared.
Jared.
And it's time for some Street Fighter V here at CEO 2016. I'm James Chen.
What's up? I'm Ultra David. We started out with a big, big bracket, and there were people here from North America, and there were people here from Europe, and there were people here from East Asia, and we've all boiled it down to just 8.
Mostly from East Asia. Mostly from me. No, but seriously, it's been a lot of very, very strong players, and we've had some great matches all weekend long, and we are down to the top 8, and it is a pretty crazy top 8. I mean, we had some guy come and look at the bracket, and he's like, this is like the bracket right here. So
as CEO is every year, it's stacked, okay? Mm-hmm. It's been that way for the last several years as people use it as not only a major event, you want to win it, pop bonus, lots of players, etc. But it's the month before Evo, and
yes,
Evo is the biggest one, and as a result, this is a testing place. You come here, you see how you're doing, you get some feedback for yourself, you sort of learn what you're doing well, what you need to work on, and so it's used that way by a lot of players, which means that it's just full of top-level talent.
That's right. And, I mean, do you want to just go over
yeah.
the... Let's just go over it.
So we'll talk about it.
So, look, here on the winner's side of the bracket, right, on the top side of the winner's side, we already have the run back of all run backs. I mean, this has been going on all year long.
Yeah.
It is Infiltration versus Tokido. They met each other in Grand Finals at Final Round. A week later, they met each other at Grand Finals at NCR. They fought each other at the Red Bull Kumite earlier this year. These guys have fought each other so many times this year.
Yeah.
And you know what? Tokido is going to want to win at some point in time.
I'll tell you, as good as Infil still is, there are some cracks appearing
yes.
in that show, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then Tokido is one of the better ones. He has one of the stronger nutcrackers out there. On the other side of winner's bracket, it looks like we have Haitani and Momochi.
Right, so two of the strongest players. Well, it's interesting because Haitani at one point in time was said to be the strongest player in Japan. And now Momochi was a player that started off. He was one of the strongest players of Ultra Street Fighter 4 at the end of that. And then when Street Fighter 5 started, it seemed like he had a character crisis. It didn't seem like he could figure it out. Then all of a sudden, you know, like in the tournaments in Korea just recently, Momochi beat Infiltration. He beat a bunch of them. He started winning a bunch of events, and Momochi now seems poised in that position that he was familiar with at the end of Ultra Street Fighter 4.
He really looks great. He really looks great so far, yeah. And I'm excited to see Haitani in yet another major top 8. Very consistent placing.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever he travels, he seems to do well. And
no
difference here. Then in loser side, who do we have? Because there's some good ones in there, too.
It's former Mad Catz teammates Daigo Umehara versus Mago. So Daigo and Mago are going to be going up against each other in loser's side bracket.
Right.
Yeah, that's crazy to me.
I spoke with Daigo a little bit about this match.
Okay.
And he had very interesting insight into it.
Okay.
He's been traveling too much lately, and he doesn't have anything new for Mago.
Look, Daigo has already gone on record to say that he doesn't even feel like he's prepared for Evo right now.
Yeah.
That he feels like he still needs to iron out some of the kinks. And look, he got sent to loser's bracket by Haitani. He has not been able to defeat Nikali. Nikali is literally his demon character right now. He says he doesn't have an answer for Nikali right now. Fortunately for him, Mago does use Karen, so we'll see how that goes. But, it's interesting. I mean, he's made a top 8 in one of the most stacked brackets ever, and he says that he's not quite ready yet. So, you know.
Well, you know, that's Daigo. Daigo has a particular level of expectation.
Exactly.
That, might be
exactly.
a little bit outside of most people's purview.
And on
Who's
the other
rest?
Side of the loser's bracket, we have Nuki. So just as a quick aside, all four of the Japanese gods that showed up to CEO have made top 8.
Okay.
Right? But he is going up against the lone American hope, Mr. Knuckledew.
Yeah, Liquid Knuckledew is still in there. Oh, hey, we're in the house, Mike. How's
That's
it going,
right.
everybody? I can hear you cheering. Let me hear you a little bit more.
There you go.
All right, people at home will have to trust me that that happened.
No, I hope everybody here is excited for some awesome Street Fighter V because these matches are going to be ridiculous. I mean, on the winner's side, we're going to be starting with Infiltration and Tokido, like I said, and Haitani and Momochi. So those two are going to be pretty nuts right away. So, and of course, as with tradition here at CEO, we're going to have some player intros as they come down to the ring to battle it out. I'm assuming that we're going to start with Infiltration and Tokido.
That's right.
All right.
That's what we're going to do. Let's check them out.
All right. There you see a bunch of the guys responsible for helping make Street Fighter to what it is today. Oh, there's Infiltration. Here is your man from Korea, Mr. Infiltration. And he has taken a picture of the crowd. Soaking in the moment.
I see he's opted for the cooler wear.
If you don't get all those ropes, I swear to God.
Got some shorts on. Can't blame him. It's a million degrees in here.
Trying to see if Infiltration wanted to pull a wrestling move in the ring, and Infiltration politely declined.
He needs those hands.
Oh, we've got the smoke coming now.
His opponent making his way to the ring. The murder face, Tokido!
Tokido all the way here from Tokyo, Japan. One of the strongest players in Street Fighter V currently, placing high in all of the Capcom Premier events. And in fact, the only man who's really been in his way in any of these Premier events is the man seated right there, Mr. Infiltration.
I'll tell you, if not for Infiltration, he has at least two Premier wins
exactly,
so far.
Exactly. And so this is his opportunity. You know that he's been thinking a lot about this. We have Mr. Kenny Omega here, cheering everybody on. Hey, keep
Oh, he got the double? That was a high five and a tap.
Keep in mind, Kenny Omega wrestles in the Japan scene. He actually told me the Japanese players were like super excited to see him.
Sick. Tokido has been strong forever.
That's what I'm talking about.
But especially towards the end of Ultra Street Fighter 4, I felt he turned the corner from being one of the best ever to being one of the most competent, which
yes.
I feel like is maybe a little bit of a different thing, right? Not only is he playing to identify the cheap stuff and you know, he's always had the strong footsies and all that stuff, but he really honed those skills to the max
right
when Akuma himself was changed. And I feel like that is to such his advantage in this game. In this game, the skills that he really, you know, sort of buffed up when he had Akuma in that version. Footsie is a little bit more about the fireball game. That is Ryu in this game.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, without him needing to learn those, I don't know that he'd be having the same success.
Now, the interesting thing is on Infiltration side, look, we know he has a Nash. We've also seen him bust out Alex before. He even played Fong earlier in this tournament, but supposedly he even has a fourth secret character. And I'm wondering if we're going to see that at any point in Top 8. But I'm guaranteeing you right now, Tokido has probably prepared for practice against Nash. Because that is the character that has stood in his way at all the previous events that they played against each other.
I think that's the most likely pick. I just like Nash versus Ryu. And when Snake Eyes played versus Infiltration earlier in this tournament, right, Info went Fang at the start versus Ryu from Snake Eyes. That didn't work. He went right to Nash. And it was 2-0 after that.
Right, so right.
That's my guess. For his character counterpick, his character pick here, I don't know if there's anything additional he has against Tokido the Human, because certainly that's a consideration. But so far, when they've played, it's looked all right. But, you know, we mentioned this before. It does seem like the cracks are starting to appear.
It's just, I feel like everybody is catching up to that level.
That's
so
what it is.
It seems like to me, Infiltration figured out how to play Street Fighter V before anybody else did. And now everybody else is, and you can look, you can see the concentration on Tokido's face. Look at him, it's so zen-like right now.
Tokido on the left of your screen, Infiltration on the right. You can see the Razer logo.
And indeed, it looks like it is going to be Nash versus Ryu. This is a grand finals of any other event. We are starting here in the first round, winner side top eight, Tokido versus Infiltration. Let's go!
See how they approach this. Of course, Infiltration is known for the movement with his Nash. It's really what sets it apart from everybody else. Wow, dash up just like that. Confirm.
Immediately goes in.
And he's very much approaching. I was looking for the backdash. I wonder if Tokido was too. But no, it was offense at the start. Taking advantage in neutral situations already. Yeah, and that's another situation. When neither party has a clear advantage on block, who takes advantage?
I love Tokido there dashing up to take advantage of the V-skill, of absorbing that fireball. Got the sweep.
And there's the back off. This is more what I expected out of Infiltration Nash.
Wow. So many.
Okay. Well, he didn't get the rest, but I love that he was expecting that.
Right. There's a little bit of delay after the parry that you can only cancel into another parry.
Really?
And here comes Infiltration pushing him into the corner. You see all those dashes to push him that way. He gets out of the corner, but Infiltration doesn't get a combo. Here we go. He's going to set it up. Does he have it? Yes. And he's going to convert into the Ultra. There it is. He's been doing that all weekend long. If you take the hit, he goes into raw Ultra. If it breaks, then he just has the combo afterwards. Super, super.
Yeah, there's the movement back and forward, back and forward. When to take up space is the question for his opponent. Okay, nice.
Yeah, got to be careful. That knee is not
the back.
Chasing down the back dash.
Yes.
And he throws the V reversal.
Super important. All right, he has his own jump throw tech. The OS fighting well from the corner right now and fully stocked on bar. He's dangerous. Oh, yes. Hit. Will he go into super? No, he goes for something else.
Wow. He just ended that combo. I'm not sure if that was an execution error or he was going for a reset. But
here
goes Tokido. That's going to be able to take it with the EX Hurricane. Tokido getting first blow. He has gone up one game to zero versus Infiltration. As you said, the cracks have seemed to have shown up, but Infiltration, of course, one of those players who's so good at adapting in the middle of a match. Let's see how he opens this one. Last time it was a forward dash. This time, just a back fist going at him.
Nice spacing on that. Will he fight more strongly in that mid-range? I wonder, rather than being back and forward, because that didn't work last game so well.
Ooh, nice parry, but that's going to be punishable, yeah. Again. I really like that Tokido started using the parries a little bit more in his game.
There's a lot of bulldogging coming out of Tokido right now. It's not so much throwing fireballs, it's trying to take up good spots with buttons, trying to move forward and block.
That Infiltration footsies right now looking so strong. An opportunity there, but was a little too far under for the cross-up kick to connect.
They stared at each other, Infil backs off. Again, hard to know when he's gonna come in. Down medium kick, whip punishing well, and he baited it.
Yeah, that time Infiltration just played a very solid footsie game. And it's like you said, he started to playing a little bit more of that mid-range game, using the Sonic Scythe a little bit more. Let's see if Tokido can adjust to that and do anything about it, because obviously Tokido was trying to get in a lot in the first game, not really playing that fireball game, so that's why Infiltration now seems to be obliging it. It says, you know what, you want to play footsies, I'm going to play this footsies game with you.
I was just about to say Super's ready to go. And Infil gets it. See what he wants to set up afterward. Will he go right back to this back and forth game up front? And he did go for the tech. Nicely done by Tokido, who himself has a trigger. He can be dangerous.
Yep, he's got a long way to go.
And he went right into it again.
Wow. But a little too far for Infiltration's punish. But Tokido still has, I mean, he's used up two resources. He doesn't have the super anymore. So it's going to be in particularly difficult.
Very unconventional stuff. It's so rare that you see an overhead with that timing. Meaty overhead? Sure. Sometimes you see dash up overhead, but to wait, then the overhead is a little bit more unusual.
Right, and that's a rough match right there for Tokido, because he had such a strong first game, and in that second game, I felt like Infiltration didn't really get challenged at all, had most of his life for most of that time. So Tokido's got to figure out, okay, he gets the jump in now for big damage. Slow push him to the corner, smart using the medium hurricane, but here we go, accidentally corners himself, and Infiltration's going to get some good damage.
Infil already used the trigger, I guess.
Now, Infiltration. So one of the strong weapons that Ryu has is that stand roundhouse, but Infiltration has had the reactions to whip punish it all the time so far.
Hold attack forward. Didn't have meter to seal it. And there he is. What perfect positioning, and he waited for it.
Yeah.
You know, he dashed in. One thing about how he plays is that he dashes in, and it's not only that he comes in with something set in mind. It's one of a couple options, and he sees whether you're there or not, and he sort of chooses among them at the last second. That's something few people can do.
All right, great reaction, showing that Tokido is still ready for that anti-air. It's always a good thing to test to see how much your opponent is focusing on the ground game.
Okay, got to confirm. Super, I believe, go up.
Ooh,
he tried.
So smart.
And a punish. Nothing else, though. Really hard to get more.
Yeah, but he knew that Tokido had got the jump on him, so he immediately canceled the V-trigger to get out of there. Tokido with a life leak here on this round.
It is interesting to see Tokido counter-poking with that stem roundhouse. It hasn't gotten him too much. Of course, right then is when it works.
Oh. There it is. Sweet. Is he going to go for the setup? There it is. Yep,
yes.
Nothing he can do. I mean, he might have been able to V-trigger. Did he have it? I'm not sure.
He built it after you.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. So Tokido now tying it up 1-1. That's important for him. Oh, in this round, I should say. It's important for him because Infiltration had just won 3 rounds in a row. You want to make sure that you can swing that momentum back around to get yourself to believe that you can still take these rounds.
There's that slippery stuff out of Infiltration. Oh, try to get the down strong. It's worked a lot. Not quite there, though.
Oh, beautiful jump back jab. Okay, out of there.
Yeah, Infiltration getting away. Yeah, just was waiting for it, I think, Tokido.
Nice, the tech!
And
there
it worked.
Is, yeah.
The intention of the Meaty Hurricane was to try to get that.
Right.
Whole point of it, but just mistimed it.
It's just a little too slow, and he's going to be able to cancel the super, and that's going to take it. So that jump back OS tech gives him that weird extra added benefit of accidentally being able to air throw that Hurricane if Tokido times it a little bit too late.
So what a lot of people are doing is blocking just a second as they get up, less than a second.
Right.
And then jumping back and pressing Light Punch, Light Kick, which is a throw tech. So if the opponent throws you, you'll tech still on the ground. And if they didn't, then you jump backward. Most characters, that comes out as a jump short.
Right.
Jump Light Kick. But for Nash, since he has an air grab, it comes out as something else. Unfortunately for Tokido, he just mistimed that Hurricane. It's not supposed to be a true meaty, but it's not supposed to be late either. There's a little bit in there where it's supposed to hit.
There shouldn't be enough time for him to jump and get the air throw off in time.
Exactly. But we've seen that a couple of times so far this weekend.
Oh, he's in there.
Snake Eyes too.
But small damage. He just came in with a jumping Light Kick instead. Oh, that's punishable. Yeah, big, big gamble on that. And see, that standing roundhouse that Tokido has been using has not been paying off quite properly for him. And he was going to get the cross up here, though,
huge
with a big damage combo.
And wake up buttons from Infiltration. A lot of people have been ending combos with something other than Fierce Shoryu to try to get a little bit more advantage.
Nice dash up throw. He could sense a little bit of tentativeness from Tokido's play. Too far for the counter hit stand medium punch. But Infiltration's going to land on there, and a dash up throw from Tokido is going to take that round. Of course, Infiltration up 2 games to 1. This is best 3 out of 5 for the whole top 8.
Too far. He got a little greedy.
Nice turnaround uppercut.
The dash forward afterward. Really, it's just a neutral situation, but he had it right. No punish on it.
Tokido sitting on a full meter now, so things are going to be a little scared. But Tokido really betting
right
a lot,
through?
But is it going to make it through? It does. It gets good damage now. Tokido with a big life lead.
What? Look at these button timings.
2 counter hits. Ooh, nice.
Infiltration
gets a throw, and Tokido's stuck in the corner now.
Gotta respect that. Big advantage after Nash does that. He's going for a grab
throw.
Again. What's it gonna be?
Another
again?
Throw.
Will he die from this?
A fourth throw! We have 4 throws
Please.
In a row!
Oh, he didn't seal with a throw, but you know what? Fine. He sealed it with something that steals meter for himself, so that's pretty sick. But when that happens, that is one of the toughest situations to deal with in any fighting game. What do you do?
Right. Is he gonna do it again? That is the hardest decision to make. Stealing that round, seriously. I mean, like, I would say that Tokido threw that round, but I think Infiltration threw it more.
Okay, the backdash helps Tokido get into the
go.
Corner now. Can he make this work for himself? It's match point Infiltration. He's gonna start off well.
Yeah, but doesn't have that big of a life leash because Tokido has a lot of meter to build, right? I mean, he has a lot of meter to use.
Will it be grab central again? No, too far, but...
So all Tokido needs to do, yep, he's got another meter now.
Anti-air
nice
was there, the great blocking. Oh, it's
an
intention, so not the end of the world, but...
Okay.
Well, I mean, basically, whatever.
Right. I mean, to be honest with you, there was really no way Tokido could take advantage of that, so
yeah.
I'm not sure if Infiltration even needed to do that at all. He kind of wasted his meter.
Well, he doesn't take as much damage that way, right?
So. Oh, that's true. Not as much chip. Ooh, got overhead. Him out of there. Oh, get an overhead.
Overhead. What is this?
And then a
what a way to seal the deal. Unbelievable. Those timings, again, with the overhead, I feel nobody in fighting games, nobody in Street Fighter at least, times their overheads with such unusual specificity.
Yeah, I mean, the last round, I mean, we saw him do this, I believe it was NCR, where he just, like, whiffed a bunch of stand jabs overhead. And that's how he took that first game as well. And this time, he hit him with an overhead, and maybe Tokido was thinking another one was going to come. But instead, he used the V-trigger to the other side, all of a sudden, out of nowhere, and just hit him with a left-right mix-up, crouching strong. He just wasn't ready for it.
I love those options. To see interesting stuff like that, yes.
Oh, man. But yeah, Infiltration once again, taking it over Tokido. Tokido is, I mean, at this point in time, at what point do you start feeling like this guy is your demon and that you're not going to be able to take him out?
I'm sure he's already there, but I don't feel he'll ever feel like he can't take him out. All right, we're going to move on to the other side of Top 8 winners. This is Haitani.
Haitani!
Giving the fist bumps along the way. Entering the ring, one of the strongest Nikali players in Japan. In fact, when Street Fighter V first started.
Is that Crazy Chili Dog in the background? I can't really hear from where I am, but I hope not. Anyway, continue.
Who's his opponent gonna be?
Not that guy.
And his opponent,
fight.
E.G. Momochi!
As I mentioned earlier, E.G. Momochi, considered one of the strongest in Ultra Street Fighter 4 towards the end. He was 2014's Capcom Cup champion, and at first, in the start of 2015, seemed almost invincible. At the start of Street Fighter V, he did not seem like he was having the same kind of success, but everything clicked all of a sudden. A lot of people were even saying maybe he should switch away from Ken and go for another character that was more fundamental-based, but he figured out Ken, and he plays him very differently than a lot of the Kens that we see here in the States. We see a lot of players like to keep the rush down, keep the pressure going. Momochi took his fundamental approach and really kind of applied it to this character. And I find that really interesting that that's the approach that he decided to take. Some people were saying that maybe he should go to Karen. Some people even said Cammy maybe to play a very footsies kind of game.
Yep.
But instead...
But that wasn't his choice, and he has done a good job. I feel like it's hard to go wrong with that character, if I'm perfectly honest. But yeah. He's really done a good job. You're right. I love his style with it. See what he can do. It's going to be Ken, expecting at least, Ken versus Nikali.
Yeah. Which is actually a pretty common matchup that we've seen quite a few times at other ranking events and such. But I'm definitely curious to see how Momochi's approach to it is going to work against Haitani.
Yeah, it can be an explosive matchup either way. And they both have kind of stubbly-ish normals. Stand Roundhouse from Nikali can have some range, but if you throw it out at the wrong spot, it's like throwing a fireball in terms of recovery. So there's some risk to it. See what their choices are. Who's going to face Infiltration in Winners Finals?
Oh, man. Either one of these is... Oh, remember, Momochi did beat Infiltration, like I said, in the Korean tournaments, right? And I can imagine right now, I wonder if Infiltration would prefer one or the other. Like, does he want revenge against Momochi, perhaps?
You know, every single time I've asked Infiltration, who do you want to face? He never says anything. He always says, ah. It's not like he does. It's not like there's some politic answer. It's just, whichever.
All right, but here we go. One of the gods from Japan, Haitani, going up against one of the strongest players in Street Fighter in the world right now, E.G. Momochi. Winner's side bracket, CEO 2016. Let's go.
Round one. Fight.
And immediately you see them starting out with already this kind of footsies walk back and forth.
What kind of misplaced on the run? There's the roundhouse.
Oh no! Accidental uppercut.
Yeah, not punished well. Both feeling each other out a little bit. It's going to be corner now for Haitani. Very cautious as he approaches.
Yeah, Haitani definitely with a better start, but wow, going for that crouch roundhouse. It's really interesting because you see a lot of the Japanese players, I feel like they go for that crouch roundhouse a lot because I'm starting to wonder if they just don't feel like that the punishment of a counter sweep is enough to discourage them from trying
it. That's so good.
That four frame punish, just like that. Look at the damage output. And just like that, all of a sudden, life lead, corner position.
Yeah.
Ken just waiting for something, hoping to convince Haitani to make a bad choice. Haitani's working on super, so he still is very dangerous. Oh, here he is. Trigger, a little bit left.
Just enough. That last hit is going to take it for Momochi. And after a great start from Haitani. Haitani had Momochi in the corner drain like half his life, but then like you said, Ken just has that ability to turn it around so fast.
I really like Momochi's approach with the air too. Ken has a couple of strong jump attacks, but that hurricane can really mix things up, move him out of the way. A lot of anti-airs.
Oh, did you see him dash right past that B skill? Haitani almost looking like taking a page out of Phenom's book right there, going with a couple of wake-up uppercuts.
Momochi really trying to move forward right now. He's almost on trigger. Has super already. Just wants that last little bit. If he can find it, he can real turn things on.
Ooh, crush counter, but oh wow, nothing.
Yes, the hit.
And just like that.
He saves the bar. Super still in there. If he finds another hit, he's going to take it.
Oh, what a dash forward by Haitani to get out of that situation.
And the blocking. Really fishing for it is Momochi. The dash even.
Yeah, smart stuff by Haitani. He got out of there, recovered all of that gray health again.
No, ooh! I think he wanted the anti-air, I gotta tell you.
Yeah, just a little too late on that, and Haitani is gonna take it with the super. He's gonna spend all of that meter, but very important to stay alive in this first game.
It's almost like he was only two or three frames off.
Final round. Fight.
Momochi sitting with a full meter, gonna spend one of them to get that corner carry and the damage, goes for the throw.
Oh, the back dash right through. It's an option we're seeing more of.
Yeah, it's the best option to avoid the throws. Ooh, and a crush counter, so he's just gonna get right in there.
Yes, working on the stun.
Ooh, just jumps right out of that corner. That is a way to defeat the throw shimmy option.
Got him. Wow, what an interesting anti-air with the air-to-air EX dive. Great round right there for Momochi, that's for sure.
Yeah, just like that, taking game one.
Haitani on the right there, chin in hands.
Yeah, most likely round not going to see a character change. Imagine these two are going to stick with these characters for the whole time.
Too far for anything else, and I like Momochi taking up the space. Roundhouse, yeah, there you go.
And you see right now, you see Haitani using the close range V skill because of that one time Momochi dashed through it. I think he's trying to bait Momochi into a forward dash into it now. See, again, they really use the sweeps a lot.
Mm-hmm. There's the answer. It's exactly what I think Momochi wanted before. This time he finally gets it.
Yeah, but I mean, Nikali's jump roundhouse does hit pretty low, so I'm wondering if it was just, you know, one of those situations he wasn't quite prepared to hit it last time. But look at this!
Well, now Ken's reward for getting beat up is that he has trigger, and he is so dangerous if he can find an opportunity. No, but Haitani's doing a great job. The overhead punish! Yes!
Wow, just like that.
We have seen a couple one-frame punishes, and you know what? He just runs into the jab. I'm sure it was going to be trigger canceled. Might have been the round itself or close to it.
Right. But that's the classic. That's the Nikali classic. Wake up, stand, jab. You have to be aware that, especially Haitani, he really loves that stand, jab, wake up. Here we go, Momochi. Even without the meter, very much good, you know, great corner carry on that roundhouse hurricane. All sitting on all that meter. You can imagine he's probably ready to spend it. Oh, just going to spend one bar because he's close to stun. Oh, crush counter, and he's going to hit confirm it and get big damage.
That's such a swing. He was almost stunned and almost dead. Well, he ends up dying, but I like that he was fighting right there.
Yeah, and Momochi throwing out a surprise wake-up uppercut that Haitani was not prepared for. Ooh, getting in with that EX Hurricane in the air. Gets a little extra juggle off of that. Again, corner carry, but throws him backwards. Out of the corner, interesting choice. Ooh.
Pressuring, oh, the whiff actually, no tech. Wow, double dash. Haitani looking for something.
Just gets out of the corner, smart from Momochi.
Really haven't seen too much in the way of strong trigger play from Nikali in this set.
Well, the guys doesn't have it quite yet.
Oh, look at this range. See, just outside of that roundhouse, just outside of that down strong, that's where Momochi is hanging out. He just doesn't want to take a risk of the activation, I think. Well, here it is anyway.
Try to get up for that throw. Ooh, gets the stand roundhouse. He wanted the DP, it was too late. And he's going to cancel the super. This is going to be a huge amount of damage.
Yeah, and good pressure because he's already in V-trigger.
So what's the mix up here? Ooh! Is that meaty standing light kick linked?
Oh, no, very unfortunate. Yeah. Very unfortunate.
Yeah, that's always that situation, and that's actually something that you can people are starting to they've talked about starting to use it as an actual strategy is to get hit by something like a crouch strong out of the air. So when they cancel it into a fireball, it puts them into a delay, and when you land, you can punish it. A lot of characters you can do that against, like Laura bolt charges, fireballs, all sorts of moves like that.
Komochi respected the wake up a little too far, maybe a little too late on the stand short. There's a whiff. Momochi backing off just a little bit. It's really felt like it's been on Haitani to make things happen. I feel like, for the most part, Momochi's been able to do it. Finds an opportunity for himself.
All the way into the corner.
V-trigger's ready. And Momochi, for Momochi now, reacting to what it is Haitani wants to do is going to be tough. He's going to have to, there's going to be a prediction in there.
Oh,
there's
prediction. Shot right past him, but nice sweep by Haitani. Not able to punish that run cancel. Oh, it baits out the uppercut. Momochi going up one round here in game three. They're tied 1-1 in this winner's set.
Okay, some trigger built. Really fishing around with that back strong. And it's a very in-close battle right now, though. Finally, Haitani backs off.
Oh, he got right in there. He's going to get the fierce uppercut juggle.
Oh, dash. Wow, okay. He's getting gutsy, paid off, but didn't get the combo. What a delay.
Backdash, uppercut. And again, missed that uppercut. You saw it looked like he was pumping for it, but instead, that jumping roundhouse from Nikali catching him before he can get the button off. And again, that neutral jump fierce doing it this time.
No stun, anything's gonna do it. He might not get a chance. Here comes
Super?
Ken.
No, he's gonna save the meter.
Yeah, I think that's important. That hit was not canceled, the overhead. Not so much because it's an overhead, but it jumped right over. By the way, I love the late Dragon Punch from Nikali in those in the left side right there.
Right.
On reaction, well, maybe not on reaction, but expecting the walk back for the 2016.
There we go, gets the jump in on there. Oh, and misses with the EX Hurricane and gets himself trapped in the corner. Wakes up with a strong.
There
oh,
it
gets
is.
The uppercut that time, yep. All right, thrown back to the middle of the screen.
Super ready for both. Yes.
And a confirming into the V-trigger cancel. Gonna get max damage off of that without spending any meter.
Yeah, waited for it. No super as a result.
Oh, and he gets him with a jump fierce again, Momochi. Again, too late with the anti-air.
Must have been the fourth or fifth time?
Yeah, I think.
It's happened quite a bit. Nikali does have some of those strong jump buttons. Okay, that is a strength of his, but clearly it seems Momochi's looking for the Dragon Punch. So I'm surprised to see him rip it a little late.
Round one.
Well, Haitani, just like that, goes up 2-1. And yeah, you mentioned that standing roundhouse before the fight started, and it's really starting to pay off for Haitani. He's really spacing it and positioning it really well. I've seen a lot of times now that Momochi's just kind of walked into it.
Yeah, oftentimes on crushes, he doesn't get serious damage, but he gets closer towards Super Saiyan, and that's a big part of it.
Meaty low strong, trying to look like he went up for a dash throw, maybe.
Momochi trying to pressure now. Wake up, jab to Haitani.
Again, see, now he's kind of scared to do that uppercut, it looked like.
Yeah, that's bad news for Momochi.
All right, confirm. Yep. Going to the uppercut. Follow up, fierce uppercut. Only works in trigger.
Oh, he had down strong. He just didn't see it too far. Not punished. Haitani patient.
Slowly chipping away so that one tiny hit can kill him.
That jump. That jump is the product of all those missed anti-airs by Momochi. Was that command grab?
I think that was just a regular throw. In any case, Momochi punishes it with the crouching medium kick. Goes up one round. Nice throw tech, throw break from Momochi. Momochi slowly trying to walk Haitani into the corner, using that dive kick to throw off the timing of the anti-air from Momochi.
Yeah, I really like these buttons on Haitani's side.
Yeah, I really feel like Haitani's been winning this mid-range footsie game. it looks like to me that Momochi has really started respecting that stand roundhouse, which has given Haitani a lot more leeway to walk forward and get in closer ranges. But just like that, that cancel is going to allow him to switch sides.
Huh. Oh. Funky choice, Momochi. There's the GP.
Yeah, punishing the neutral jump.
Super's almost there. He jumps now. And blocking there was Haitani.
And had to spin the meter to make the target combo safe. Oh, he's going to catch him on the forward dash. And Momochi confirms into the EX Hurricane. And he ties it up 2-2.
Kind of a bemused expression on Haitani's face. Come on. Two, two. Who gets to play against Infiltration in Winners Finals? Yeah, that up-close battle's so funky between these two characters. They have such, not necessarily similar tools, but the game plan is kind of similar in that range.
Oh wow, uppercutting right through there. That is a hit confirm. Standard hit confirm combo for Ken. And I guess Haitani knew that it wasn't a true block streak, so he uppercut right in the middle there. It's going to make it a little bit harder for Momochi to continue hit confirming low strong and to stand short if Haitani keeps uppercutting in between there.
I like the spacing from Momochi. He's been outside of what Haitani wants to do quite consistently in this round. Yes!
Ooh, gets him with that, and he's going to be able to confirm into a nice corner carry combo.
Oh, that would have been so big. Here comes Haitani now.
the disrespect!
The guts!
Oh, wow. Run cancel, very rarely used by Momochi.
Right, but it's one of those big crisis situations, so interesting timing for it. Mm-hmm. Haitani was ready, though.
And he's sitting on so much meter right now. Any hit can lead into a super.
He's
and there
it
is!
Didn't even need it. Doesn't. You know what, that's lucky for Haitani. That he's going to start this next round with a full super. He was willing to use it, I'm sure. He's already done that in the set. Match point now, trying to get into winner's finals. What spacing on that roundhouse? Back and forth. Here comes Ken now. Momochi with the knockdown. And very patient afterward.
All right. Gets him with the frame trap. Stand jab into back strong. But there's that wake up uppercut. Again. That time just as the anti-air.
Momochi has super. Not anymore. The pressure more important, I guess. Oh, interrupted into nothing. Air to air. He has it too. Gotta respect this. He did not! Haitani air to air. There's his own disrespect from Momochi. We're going to the last round.
Final round.
And they're both basically sitting on full meters. So they're, oh, and they both just spent one just like that. So very even resources, but unfortunately for Haitani, he's down about half life already. Another throw.
Will he get stunned if he gets stunned? Oh, boy. He might still.
Dashed up and got him again. The throws disrespect that we've seen from Infiltration and now from Momochi.
He has all the resources. If he can find a hit, he's not going to. It's a perfect to seal it. How about that? Momochi with the perfect. He moves on to winner's finals against Infiltration. Haitani will go to the loser's side. We'll see how he does. He's not out of it. That was as close as could be, with the exception of the last round.
Wow.
Hey, Momochi. if you want to see who's in, I mean, we'll show you the bracket. But on top of that, if you want to find out, you know, who did what,
right,
how this weekend went, you can check it out at smash.gg. Click on CEO right there on the front page. Check out the bracket. Then click on Street Fighter V, and everything is in there.
Right, exactly. You can see the whole history of how the tournament went, who knocked out who, how people got sent into loser's bracket. As I mentioned, we have Daigo in loser's bracket. He got sent there by Haitani. Trying to see if I can see. Momochi sent Mago to the loser side bracket.
I see. Infiltration got into winner's finals here in top 32 by beating, we just saw Tokido, of course. And before that, looks like it was XSK Samurai, Goichi. That's a pretty good list. We're moving to the loser side, though.
Daigo Umehara!
Umehara! It is Daigo, the beast! The global ambassador for Twitch.
That's right. New job.
Exactly.
Fanciest possible title.
Like I said, it's interesting to me because Daigo, a man with the kind of standards that he has for himself, You know, here he is in top eight at CEO, one of the most stacked brackets, telling himself that he doesn't feel like he's ready for EVO quite yet. And yet here he is, top eight, CEO. He is in loser side bracket, but he's still in a great position.
Did you hear that it was indestructible?
Was it?
That was his music.
Okay, good stuff.
You guys might recognize this man.
Of course, Mago, formerly part of that Mad Catz trio alongside Tokido and Daigo.
Nice, one of the nice music choice.
Trying to decide which side that they're going to play on.
That's not irrelevant in this game. I mean, we're at a point where, of course, everybody can do Dragon Punches on both sides. That's not it. But right. Who gets to control whether you play another round? That's relevant in this game. Who has to tell the other person that they want to keep playing or not?
And already, Daigo striking the first blow, throwing rock, defeating Mago with scissors. Daigo using the Justin Wong strategy. Always throwing rock against Japanese players because they like to do scissors.
They like the peace sign.
Yes,
funny
exactly.
Haitani is the one who sent Daigo to losers. That was 2-1.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mago, as you said, was sent there by Momochi.
Of course, don't forget, at CEO, remember at this time last year, Mago was just on a roll. He had won so many events in Europe and in Asia. And a lot of people were saying maybe he was turning into the best player at the time with his Yang. Well, with his Yang, I should say.
Yeah, well, in this game, too, he's had a marquee win of his own, and he followed it up with basically Bupkis at the next tournament. So we'll see if he can start trying to carve out a little bit more consistency for himself. After he was sent to losers, he beat Wolfram. Okay, that's how he made it where he is. And Daigo, after he was sent to losers, he beat Lud. Lud beat Ludovic. Lud had a strong run this weekend.
Yeah, he took out Kazunoko earlier in the round. So Daigo has Lud to thank for not having to face up against Kazunoko. And here we go.
Characters we expect. It's Ryu versus Karen. That's Daigo on the left, of course. Umehara has played Ryu in every version of Street Fighter, including in Third Strike round when one. Ken was Ryu.
Mm-hmm. Fight. And Evil, and even in Ultra Street Fighter 4, he just went.
Yeah,
went
when Evil Ryu was Ryu.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah.
Sometimes it's not Ryu, but you know, it's always Ryu.
All right, Mago gets the sweep in there, goes in with a shoulder. Safe on block. Oh, just goes in for the throw. That's why that stand light kick is so good as a meaty attack. If you get it right, and you get the counter hit, you can combo in the crouching strong and finish off her combos from there, finish off her bread and butter.
Great advantage on it.
All right, Daigo's got the uppercut there. Wow, Mago just going with the wake up. EX right now, just establishing that as early as possible. Wow,
corner.
That almost looked like Daigo took a step to throw Mago walking backwards.
The whiff punish.
Tries to go for the frame trap with the background house. Mago not going to bite. Just trying to poke
him. Oh, he went overhead? Really?
Really?
I can't believe he did that. That is something I haven't seen in top-level competitive play in a while. Maybe that's why it worked.
Right. I mean, look, earlier we saw Goichi was punishing Justin's Rekkas all the time with super afterwards. Maybe Mago was like, oh, he knows he can punish the backdash with something. So he just went with the overhead to just kind of throw in that monkey wrench. Not a punish, but Mago's going to get his punish. Dashing up to try to push him in the corner. Didn't get the confirm off of low strong.
Mago trying to control.
Nothing off of the crush counter stand roundhouse.
Daigo has such a fundamental Ryu in this game. Sometimes he'll turn it on. He's looking for counter. He doesn't even need counter. He used the stand strong super.
He wants that stand strong super to kill. I think that's why he hasn't spent it, but he's going to spend it here. Not going to be quite death, but going to have a big life lead. But look at Mago's resources, which are not going to come into play this round.
Nope.
Final round. But they're still here in round three. Fine. So distinct advantage goes to Mago right now. Any hit into a super right now will give him a half life lead and we'll be able to build up into another super potentially by the end of the round. But Daigo already at one bar. Oh, here he's in. He spends one bar for that. So he's going to spend another bar for
the
extra juggle.
Oh, wow. The counter, alpha counter. Backdash, perfect timing. Again, damage. Stun. Yes. Daigo sees it. Was just waiting.
Wow.
And then the very late crouching medium kick. Here's Daigo now. He still has trigger left.
Oh, cross counter up
and
again.
The stun. That might be it. It's going to be because he just built super. That will seal it.
He doesn't even need the super. And the extra stun off of the uppercut from the V-trigger Ryu is what allowed him to get that win that round. Everything was going so much Mago's way, and then all of a sudden, Daigo just turned it on. Gets the crush counter out of the air with the stand roundhouse, juggled into the V-trigger uppercut. Oh no, had to have been an execution error from Mago. And there's Daigo going behind him with the hurricane and then throwing him back in the corner. Bad punish from Mago, caught him out of the air.
Yeah, here's Mago now with the corner chance. Wow, the MK jump.
All right, gets the crush counter sweep. Goes for the safe jump setup. Counter hit, crouching jab. Gonna confirm into crouching medium punch.
Oh, big opportunity.
Just like that. I mean, look at this. Daigo still has a life lead at this point.
Daigo has not been worried about getting backed up. I feel like that's part of his game plan. Sure, now he's fighting for it, but before then, he's been doing damage as he's walked backwards.
Now, Mago's gotta be careful. That, I don't think, in the shoulder is a true block streak. If Daigo's sniffs that out, he might be able to uppercut in between there.
Karen now has triggers. She can get one of these medium kicks. It can actually be a big deal. Stand around us as well. Wow, what a counter poke.
And the neutral jump. Oh, but he's not going to be able to get the crouching strong in time. But Daigo is going to land the cross up. And he's going to finish that combo off. And he's going to, again, take another round that looks like Mago had the control for.
Yeah, and a lot of these rounds, I feel like Mago has had at least some good situation for himself. Maybe not the big lead, but, you know, corner control, something like that. And it just always seems to melt.
Wow.
All right. Sometimes you got to do it. You have to make the opponent respect your willingness to bring out an invincible option. Here's the corner.
Nice.
Daigo out of the corner now. Ready on all resources. Wake up, jab. Mago hoping for something. Trying to delay things, and you can see the different timings on the delays too. Only one of them hit.
Mago trying to maintain that pressure, using even the V reversal just to stay in there. Crush counter sweep and smart. Daigo switches the side, and he's gonna be able to come.
Is it gonna be the same sort of thing? Will this all melt? It looks like it might. Is that gonna be enough? It is! Again for Mago. He had such dominance throughout most of that round. Corner was there, harassing with buttons well. And it, just like that, it melted again.
That throw tech OS happens anytime you have to guess between throw or, you know, the shimmy, right? So Daigo, once he got that cross up, he faked it and then went short hurricane, and that was what we saw Tokido wanted to do with the meaty hurricane. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not just on wake up, but it's also after the cross up block. Yeah. You know, you have that advantage, he throws out that light hurricane. Mago tried to jump back using that tech, got caught, and Daigo was able to confirm into super and, again, steal another round. I feel like Daigo has just stolen so many rounds from Mago here.
He has really turned it on in those big moments, and maybe that's part of why he's willing to walk back a lot in the set so far, although right now he's doing a different thing. Let's see if he changes it up in what he hopes will be the final game. I don't know, not punished.
Gonna be safe on that cross up. Wow, look at this harassment from Daigo, but nice counter poke from Mago, getting right through there, getting some good damage and getting a good confirm.
There's that range that Daigo likes to be at in this match. There's the knockdown with V reversal, some great life, and the MK jump again.
Yeah. But you see that when Daigo does jump, he did come out with the light kick, so I think that was a forward jump version of that jump OS tech.
Those jumps, you know, there have been anti-airs from Mago occasionally, but just not consistently enough. And now there's that range from Daigo again, back to where he hopes he can convince Karen to make something unsafe happen. No, he moved in at the wrong spot. Cooper's there. Will he use it?
Yes. Gonna get as much damage as he can. Spend all of his resources here to take this round. Let's hear it, audience.
Round two. Fight.
All right, Daigo starting this round, however, with pretty much full resources, yet full super now.
Mago with the approach. Jumping at a great range where if he had pressed roundhouse, it might have hit, but if not, empty jump. Daigo trying to feign something, hoping to convince Mago to make a bad move. No, but Mago just moving forward. The jumps are few, and when they've come, they're pretty safe. She's building up V-Trigger. Looking for a lot of fishing for stuff. Thacko finally does get hit, but he's done a pretty good job defensively. Ah.
You know what? I really like Mago's use of the V-Reversal. That's really... He hasn't...
Hey, big jump! That's going to be the game for Mago, barring craziness. Yeah, there it is.
Look, I think Mago understands that. You know what? Karen's V-Trigger really isn't all that great. It's good for confirming stand roundhouses and extending that combo, but the mix-up off of the wreck basically is non-existent.
It's not
right?
that credible. Yeah, you know, when I first saw it, I was confused. What's this V-Trigger about? But having played the game a lot more now, I realize she's great at building V-Trigger.
Right.
And so she has it frequently. It probably shouldn't be super great, right? And her V-Reversal is legit. It's a knockdown, not all the characters are, obviously.
And so I feel like Mago is, you know, the smart thing that he's doing right now is he's just saving his V-Trigger meter pretty much almost exclusively for V-Reversals now. And I like that because he's reversing any momentum that Daigo gets.
Slowly walking forward, the Bulldog. And there's the dash right at the moment he needed. There's the tech, the jump back throw tech. Okay, down fierce. This time he gets something incredible. I like that. What?
Wow, he just goes for a standing roundhouse. You know, he's done that a couple of times, and he's thrown out a low strong, and Daigo's blocked it.
Yeah.
I almost feel like he threw out a slower move so that Daigo would wait just a little longer and then maybe go for a throw.
I'm sure that's what it is, but it was just really smart, interesting move.
Oh, wow. Interrupting that fireball. Oh, a little too close for that sweep. And a wake up crouching jab is going to get the counter hit. So he can confirm into the crouch strong, and here comes Mago. Mago, with all the momentum, gets another throw, and this time he baits it out, but he doesn't get the combo.
Just the side switch instead of the short hurricane for the super. Daigo has V-Trigger, has super. Nice snipe on the sweep.
If Mago had landed that combo, he would have had the stun.
He didn't buffer it. Hard to have seen that he should. Here comes Daigo now. Will he go into Dengen? Will he try to save it for something?
Ooh.
The staring contest. There's an opportunity
in the super. That is the stand medium kick confirm.
That was so good. That was so good. I've seen stand medium kick confirm into V-Trigger cancel super, but to add in the extra roundhouse just to milk it a little bit more. So nice.
Missed that. Yeah, again, Mago pretty much had that round if he had just confirmed that one combo they dropped. Okay, he's going to get the stun. Oh, no, he still missed it off of that.
It's so important that Daigo uses those V-meters. Lower his stun each time.
Yeah. Oh, and again, a delay. And Mago now with some drops. Maybe the nerves getting a little bit to Mago, but Mago with a huge life lead here. Oh, he should be able to punish. Yeah, Karen sweeps. Such great range. And that is going to do it. Mago's going to tie it up. 2-2. He went down 0-2 and has won two in a row. And it looks like to me Mago has been getting so much play out of EX Command Dash and then just getting right in Daigo's face and putting a slight delay on there and then hitting a button. I would not be surprised if Mago did Command Dash into throw.
Sure. That would make a lot of sense.
Instant throw the next time.
As sort of the extra wheel on the wheel of options, right? The extra spoke to hold everything up. Yeah, no, I like it a lot. I like it a lot.
Because Daigo seems to be waiting longer and longer for that button press. And that's how you stop that, is you just go for the throw instantaneously. He went for a regular command dash, not the EX one. And now Daigo looks like he's going to try to go to a fireball game here.
You know, he has had moments where he's been playing very fireball heavy, very movement heavy, very forward, and then very defensively. He's really mixed it up well.
And again, that counter hit jab, but a little bit too far for him to get that juggle. Wow. Confirmed after that standing light kick. Must have just saw the forward dash and reacted to that. And he's going to get the cross-up combo and the stun.
That orange, and he builds meter. And there's Daigo now sitting pretty at match point. Loser's side. Daigo said he didn't have anything new for Mago, but hey.
Hey, if match the old point. Works, the right. old works. And again, very important to look at the super meters there. They're very even. Oh, there it is again, using the hurricane to beat the jump back OS. Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. I don't think that was intentional. I feel like that must have been something else that went awry.
And it was so unexpected that Daigo didn't even punish it properly.
Right. Great block. The knockdown.
Right in the
crap. The crap.
Yeah, there it was. There it was. Daigo was thinking the same thing.
You're right. So Daigo now playing patiently. Oh, no. Ooh, landing recovery punish was not there.
Daigo could have just waited and punished, but I think he just didn't see what he had blocked.
Mako's out. It's got the corner control for himself so he can make something finally happen.
Oh, the jump back. You saw right there.
Here we go. I think Daigo was looking for the cross up. Mako now is in a big situation for himself. Steven still.
Wake up uppercut from Daigo. Oh, he's got the crush counter. There it is into that. And he's going to do a wake up.
Too far. And the overhead hit.
Clips him just on the heel of her shoe. Mako's going to take it to the last round here.
It's match point for Daigo. It's match point for Mako. Daigo starting off with the anti-air. Convinced Mako to jump. Forward now is Daigo into the corner. Is this an offense round? Is that the goal? Mako taking control.
This is loser's side. The loser is sent home. Two matches in a row, down to the last game, last round.
Look at that great damage. It has been building. Yeah, he'd love to take it off. There's 50. There's 100 of it. Look at all that. It's still there. Mako is there. It is. Matt with 100 damage fireball.
Oh, but he's going to get the combo off the sand roundhouse. Wow. Didn't go for any knockdown. Just went for continued pressure.
Okay, the knockdown, the little delay just in case, looking for crown hit stuff.
And now Daigo, he baits it out! And that's gonna do it for Daigo Umehara, the one time he blocked the EX.
What a moment to try it. There really hadn't been too many wake-up uppercuts on either side, but both of them went for it in the final game. And that was the wrong moment. What can you do? For Daigo, when he did it, it was the right moment. Sometimes it comes down to that.
Yep. Five games in a row coming right down to will he uppercut or not?
That's part of what I like about a fighting game matchup is that, sure, there's all this excellent spacing. That's the stuff that I really go for. But then when it comes to those individual decisions, all right?
Yes.
Those long sets, three out of five?
Mm-hmm.
Came down to that final thing. If that had been hit on the other side, who knows what Mako would have done.
Right.
If in the previous round or two when Daigo did EXDP wake up, if that had been blocked, who knows, right? It's those little things. I feel like once you get to a level like this, everything is on the edge of a knife, which is awesome to watch.
Right, and it really comes down to just, I mean, that's what Street Fighter is do you have the mental fortitude to continue making these decisions intelligently? But here we go. On the other side of loser's bracket, Nuki, one of the gods from Japan.
A god in a bunch of different games. One of the best all-time Chun-Li players in ST, Super Turbo, in Third Strike.
In a great Bishamon player,
yes,
in the
Bishamon.
Vampire games.
Yep. And also, by the way, sick commentary.
Yes.
Sick commentary. Who is the last one? It's the lone American.
That is right.
And it's the lone non-East Asian player. We had people from Europe here too, and that didn't cut it.
What? Huh?
And here's the chance of USA.
And his opponent! Knuckle Doo,
not only hailing from USA, but hailing from this very state, Florida.
Not too far away. The Tampa region is not that far. And so there's a lot of connection between where we are in Central Florida and where he lives and has lived. And Alex DeBailey, the dude what runs this tournament, is one of those connections. Everybody cheering on Knuckle Doo. Knuckle Doo has been one of the best U.S. players in this game and in the last game and in Street Fighter Cross Tekken and really just in the Street Fighter universe for a good while now.
Mm-hmm.
And I think to especially periods in Ultra, he seemed like he was the number one. And here he is, the sole representative of anywhere that's not in East Asia.
He was one of the only, I think it was two players who made top eight at Evo last year from the U.S. So was easily one of the best players of Street Fighter 4 at the time.
Yeah, for sure. Now, I did talk with him a little bit. He is not bullish. I'll tell you, he doesn't believe super strongly in his ability, but I've had that conversation with him before.
And he's come out on top?
And he's come out on top, yeah. He did have some Chun practice against a very strong Chun player
yes.
Who you know, he just didn't feel like he did everything he needed to do against.
Right.
Right.
So he actually felt – I talked to him as well.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. He played against Ricky Ortiz a lot,
right.
Had a lot of practice.
That's right. So he's played against a Chun. Certainly it's a different Chun. And there were some things that we saw Nuki do yesterday that I haven't seen another Chun do. I'm thinking in particular, I think, of the meaty fireball in the corner setup that actually beat Ken wake up DP and kept Ken grounded and allowed him to continue the combo, which was super good. So he has all the things. He always has. He's one of the gods of Japanese fighting games.
For a reason, yeah.
Right, and I mean, a bunch of those guys are in here. Daigo, Nuki,
Haitani's
in here as well, right.
The only one that
Tokido.
Did, yeah, and Sako was the only one who's
Sako.
Out of there, and he didn't come out, so.
Right, right. So
but
it's
everybody,
gonna be Nash.
Everybody here at CEO and everybody at home, I'm sure you're all excited for your U.S. representative here, Mr. Knuckledew, going up against Onuki. Let's go.
CBZ Onuki, Liquid Knuckledew. I talked with Du about character choice. He said it's pretty much going to be Nash. Maybe we'll see Mika if things seem like they're going terribly, but he said he expects it'll be Nash. Wow, just at the wrong timing for Du, but perfectly placed for Nuki.
Nice. That's great reaction to beat that air lightning kick.
Yes.
That is something that you have to say. Wow, that was
oh,
beautiful.
Yeah? Funky escape.
Wow,
right
catching
there.
Him out of the air with the Sonic Scythe beat them.
Okay, here comes Trigger, trying to pressure a little bit. Just an empty jump rather than the legs. Now, where's he going? Right back to the other side.
Yeah, no, that's really smart. That's
the
setup,
great.
And if they don't do the quick ride, then you immediately convert it, and he stays from the front! Catches Nuki off guard.
Sure.
What a throw tech. And the V-Triggers run out. So now, at this point in time, Knuckledew not only is just a barely right here for this round. Oh, great punish!
Yeah, that really was, actually. Okay.
Okay. Spends the meter to take that round. Smart. Still has two bars left.
I love Du's wake up in the corner with the trigger rather than going out of the corner like almost everybody would have. He stayed in, which is why Nuki blocked the wrong way.
Classic frame trap right there. Oh, and he gets in! Great prediction on the fireball. Able to confirm the combo. Try to shimmy there. Gets the Sonic Scythe and close the stun, and there it is! He gets the crouching light kick stun, and he has a full bar. Gonna cancel right into super, and Knuckledew is gonna take this first game with a perfect!
It's funny, we just talked about it, how he seemed like he wasn't that optimistic and said, well, I've seen him do it before, even when he's not optimistic. Oh, well, that's a way to start. Maybe to give himself a bit of feeling there. Pump himself up a little bit.
We all know, very, very emotional player. Used to do the Guile glasses to kind of hype himself up. That ended definitely there. It's definitely a confidence boost getting a perfect against someone as strong as Nuki. Now remember, Nuki also kind of skipped the entire Street Fighter 4 generation and his return for Street Fighter 5 got sponsored as well.
He was one of the best Chuns in early vanilla and then he really stopped, yeah.
Yeah.
Du's setting it up. The dash forward, though, I love that. He just, you know, Nuki knows where he can take space and where he can't. But how can Nuki get in at this point? Of course, he can slide under. Knuckledew still trying to be shifty.
Oh, wow. Just a little bit too early on that crouch drop, but not much. And that time he tried to punish it, but two really key throw techs after.
From the front, it hit again? I wonder what Nuki is doing there. Maybe he wanted stand short anti-air? I gotta think that he
would hit a button.
He had some plan there. I don't think he just got hit. But that V-trigger, as all V-triggers do, sucks out the opponent's input. You can't
right.
press a button while it's happening. You have to wait just a little bit.
There's that. Oh, wow. Not expecting the cross under. I mean, that's the standard chummy mix-up.
Okay.
And gets the air lightning kick.
The Rose close medium kick works.
Oh, he went for the instant air head stomp to get the stun. And
what? He didn't do anything. He had super. It was like he was waiting for another attempt. Well, that's lucky news for Nuki.
Not punishable.
Big chance. No, too far. Lucky for Nuki again. Can Nuki follow up and try to make something happen? I like the idea of getting over that, but no. Wow, that was a read right there.
Something Knuckledew has obviously been looking for, that air lightning kick. He's crouched strong it a bunch of times and even missed it a couple of times, but I like that he hasn't been discouraged.
Number one thing right now for Du is doesn't want to get down strong by Chun, right? That's the goal. Okay, so just blocking as a result. staying away from it.
Yeah, you
Nuki
saw it right
would love
there.
To get close.
Yeah, Nuki tried to fish through. Oh, double dash in the throw. Not quite, but Chip, Chip, he's got Chip. Wow, he just spent all of his meter on the EX and then went for the low forward instead of saving it for a super Chip.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised to see the low forward. It's, I believe it's a very slightly advantaged EX boom. The second EX boom, I think it's plus one, plus two. And then down medium kick, if I recall, is 8 frames. So there's kind of a gap in there. But he was the right call.
It was just enough for Nuki to hit a button in between and get caught.
Yeah.
And Knuckledew going up 2-0 versus Nuki here in the loser's bracket. Ooh, that was so nice. But again, Knuckledew, you see, using that jump light kick to try to air Chun-Li. That's punishable. Gets the sweep. Now, look at this. Knuckledew going for the Sonic Broom game now.
Right there.
Oh, what a jump in. Gonna go right in the Tragedy Assault.
Anti-air, yes, he was ready.
Have to be ready for the neutral jumps when you're going for throws. Ooh, gets in there.
This is such good corner pressure. I really have to say, Duke has found a rhythm for himself, and Nuki needs to make some major changes if he is to stay alive.
But right now, Knuckledew on match point here in game three. Can he seal the deal? But look at that, a beautiful jump in from Nuki. He's gonna start the round with about 20% life taken off from Nash, from Knuckledew. Ooh.
Okay, here's something that Nuki needs. He needs this pressure to work, and he gives up the corner. Just didn't pay off. You know, he got a little bit of damage, but now he's in a bad way.
Again, double dash in the throw.
Okay, a chance.
Empty jump, low forward. Caught Knuckledew by surprise.
Big jump in. No. And the legs really just haven't paid off that much.
His reactions have been amazing, but here we go. Nuki is going to get in there on that last demoralizing hit of the bird kick. Oh, he's taking off so much life. Gonna give Nuki that round. Still match point for Knuckledew. Oh, there, beautiful lightning kick.
Yeah, it's a cute idea by Knuckledew for the anti-air, but that was not the right choice.
Beautiful EX bird kick. Stop that cross-up. Okay, EX. Knuckledew's gonna spend the meter for that EX, so now...
No, just move back too far. That's how the move works. But Knuckledew's been very, very buttonsy. And he's been able to take up... Yeah, the reactions are there. Predictions as well. He knows what to look out for at any one moment.
Ooh.
Wow, tricky. Super, he wants it! He got it! That's gonna be two, he stays alive. CBZO Nuki is out of there.
Knuckledew, the last US hope, still alive here, moving on in loser's bracket. Nash wins.
Well, of course, the home country folks are pretty happy about it. And there are naturally still several representatives for Japan in the house, so it's not over for them.
Right.
But it is interesting that that was one of the Japanese gods, and that's out of there.
Yeah, so absolutely.
And good showing by Nuki. I really liked a lot of what he did this weekend, and I hope he sticks with this game because I loved seeing him in Third Strike and in early SF4, and I was always kind of sad to see him not play that game more, so I'd love to see him more.
Also, just make sure you visit Amazon.com/Capcom Pro Tour. Pick up an official Capcom Pro Tour t-shirt. I really do like that Fudin Kazan shirt there on the bottom right. It's from Ryu's sign in the stage of Street Fighter 2, also printed on his belt.
Okay.
And check out CapcomProTour.com for all of the Street Fighter information here for the Capcom Pro Tour to see the schedule for all upcoming events. Follow them on all social media at Street Fighter. Once again, we're all just chilling here. All the players, us, the commentators, we're sitting here on these nice Vertigear chairs. Check them out at 4gamergear.com. Follow them on Twitter and on Facebook at Vertigear.
Been pretty good so far, but you know what? We're going to take a look at some of the previous stuff from earlier. Let's check that out now. That is Infiltration. Still looking like one of the best.
Man.
Look at that. That is just... Look, partially that's Tokido's fault.
Right,
okay? But it looks so sick.
And there it is. Infiltration took it with the super. And of course, like we mentioned, Tokido and Infiltration have fought each other so much.
Oh, was this the series? That's two. That's three.
Do I get another four? There it is.
Like I said, that's just one of the toughest things to deal with in fighting games. What do you do about the fourth whatever?
Right.
The fourth grab, the fourth DP. It's, you know, just a guess. Speaking of guesses, RPS.
and Daigo, of course, going up his fellow against his fellow team. And there, like I said, that crush counter and then the V-trigger uppercut, getting the stun and then taking it here in the corner. And finally, that last EX from Mago, baited out by Daigo, proper punish. Daigo moves on the loser's side.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So just to talk about who is remaining on winner's side, Infiltration and Momochi. Okay, that's going to be winner's finals. We'll have that in a little bit. On the other side, in losers, we're going to have, speak of the devil, Tokido on the left, Umehara Daigo on the right, and then other side of losers bracket will be Haitani against Knuckledew.
I think Daigo right now is basically saying, playing a can you get back into Mad Cats matches right here. He's defeated Mago, so Mago's staying out. Let's see if Tokido can work his way back in. He's got to do it by defeating Daigo.
Let's see their differences in the style.
Yeah, it's interesting because the last time they played each other, Tokido did defeat Daigo. And in fact, Tokido has had the upper hand against Daigo in this mirror match the last few times they have played each other.
So Daigo in the white, that's Tokido in the blue. It tends to be, I feel, that Tokido is a little bit more of a bully, more of a brawler. As Ryu, that is to say, more comfortable playing close up. But sometimes Daigo does that too. You know, they both have the ability to do all the different styles. Just what do they want to concentrate on? I feel so far like Daigo was happy to play this ranged game.
It's just really interesting. You see the difference in the button choices. Daigo likes that standing medium kick, and Tokido loves the standing roundhouse. He's willing to throw the standing roundhouse a lot to fish for those crush counters. Right there, Tokido going with that standing medium kick.
Okay, he gets to cancel it. Daigo, see if you can get anything out of this. Oh wow, okay, spending it on that. Just maybe trying to melt off some V-trigger time.
Wow, that standing medium kick just stuffing the fireball. Wake up standing jab from Tokido. And that's going to take round one for Tokido.
There was a lot of bulldogging from Tokido in that round, and he took up a lot of good spaces with things like medium kicks. And he reacted to both forward dashes that Daigo had. Down strong was one, the second one closed out the round right there. So Daigo's going to have to change things up a little bit, either try to fight from farther or try his own bulldogging, try his own offense.
See, there you go. You see Tokido going with that stand heavy kick, something that he fishes with that I don't see Daigo fish with a lot. Daigo plays definitely more fundamentals, more fireballs.
Yeah, you can really see the difference in the style, I think. See how few fireballs Tokido throws? When he throws them, it's really just to nullify and then maybe reset the situation, just like that.
Right. Like I said, Tokido not scared to throw out that sweep because I think he knows the worst you're going to get is a punish counter sweep, which you can quick rise off of. It's not like it's ever going to be a crush counter. And if he lands a crush counter on his sweep that he's fishing for, it gives him a lot.
Mm-hmm. Oh, just escaped. Oh, well, it's clever.
Yeah, but if he hadn't done that, if he had come down with the cross up, he might have been able to punish that with crouch roundhouse.
Yeah, hard to see in advance. Well, here's a chance for himself. Saves the bar.
Daigo's so good. He understands that he always wants to spend the meter only when it kills. And he said that that's one of the strategies he said. He will save the fireball for chip kill, for combo kills, because you can always build a full bar as Ryu in the course of one round.
Okay, well now it's on Tokido to play a more active offensive role, and that is what he's doing. So the super's gone.
But Tokido has it!
What a jump. That is just crazy. He had jumped forward like that from that range. I don't know if that happened the entire game. It was only at the very end after having convinced Daigo that he's not going to do it. There had been so much walking forward, so much reacting, or you know, reacting to Daigo rather than playing preemptively.
Right.
And that's in part why that preemptive stuff works.
But it was just like that Mago situation, right? That one decision to make. Do you do the EX or block it? What do you do? Same thing when you jump over a fireball. It came down to that one decision that Tokido made. Made it over the fireball. Was able to confirm into the super, get all that damage, and take that first game. Yeah, again, you can see that Daigo definitely plays a much more defensive style Ryu, and
right.
Tokido always trying to dash in there and walking forward.
Very clear difference.
Yeah, Daigo walks backwards more than he walks forward. Tokido definitely moves forward more than he goes back.
Oh, wow. Nice catch!
Daigo just going to
And Daigo, rather than pressuring, he just continues to throw the fireball game. That's clearly where he's comfortable. That said, it just seems like, not in this game alone, but when they've played before, it seems like Tokido's style is the more successful in the mirror. Maybe it's just the way Tokido's playing it.
There we go. That was maybe the first time I've seen Daigo manage to get that forward dash without Tokido countering with that crouching strong. Oh, again, there it is. So Daigo seems like he's changed his timing on that forward dash a little bit, maybe. Catching Tokido off guard.
Oh, nice. That was real good.
Yeah.
And the fireballs did pay off. So Tokido got a little bit hurried at the end there. No chip kill in that situation, but he wanted to move forward. Some fireballs to start things off from Tokido, but then that's just not the MO, right? Yeah, right back into this looking for a way to get it. Neutral jumping, trying to get through. When I say bulldogging, what I mean is that he's walking forward and blocking.
Oh wow, gets the cross up short, but no confirm off of it, interesting. But he does have good position, and this is really important for Daigo, because like I said, he spends a lot of time moving backwards, so the more stage that he has to move backwards, the more he gets to continue playing his game.
Absolutely. Okay, stabs in with the sweep. Can he get anything good? No, okay, a knockdown. I like how Daigo took control immediately, but right back in there. Tokido, he could have certainly.
Yeah.
If he's a block, you can drag a punch.
But it's just, you're scared in those situations. You're like, oh!
Yep. Okay, Daigo now with maybe some forward movement. No Dragon Punch himself.
Wow.
And that means Tokido's in. And Tokido has super.
He threw the light kick after that standing roundhouse.
Right. The down jab. I love it to take control from Daigo rather than just blocking. Tokido wants something.
No.
He's not going to get it.
Couldn't quite get it. Just kept reaching. And then Daigo slapped away the hands. And he's going to take that second game. It's tied 1-1 here. And again, it's the contrasting in styles. It's so interesting to watch the way these two approach the footsies.
Yeah.
It really is. It's so great to watch.
Yeah,
just
I love
how they play that neutral game.
Right, yeah, I mean, it's really a testament to how differently you can play the same character in Street Fighter and in any fighting game. Your personality can really shine through. Tokido wanting to move forward, Daigo wanting to play a distance game, same tools, different uses. A little bit more maybe range here from Tokido, maybe he's trying to just get that gray life back, no dice. Oh, no full punish! And at the same time, I was just going to say, I feel like we're seeing more active stuff from Daigo, but right then was the jump from Tokido. This time not saving it for the end.
Alright, gonna activate the V-trigger off of that sweep. Kinda uses it, looks like, to gain a little bit more space back. You see how whenever, it's like when Daigo activates the V-trigger, that's his forward motion movement timing.
The knockdown, and he went in this time, it wasn't just meaty fireball.
Right, so
Daigo
won. Throw.
Oh, just one. Okay.
Nice poke with that stand medium kick. Like I said, that seems to be Daigo's main footsie tool of choice.
Yeah, why not? It's great. And Tokido was doing the same thing. When the set started off, Tokido was the one interrupting fireballs with his stand medium kick. Tokido in the blue. And, well, he tried to confirm it, not the rest.
Yeah. I mean, normally when you just hit that stand around, you just go to stand light kick into something, but he went into crouch jab for some reason. Ooh, not quite fast enough to whiff punish that whiff sweep. Nice anti-air from Daigo, showing that he's concentrating on the anti-air as well as the ground. Ooh! There's sometimes when you get that counter hit like that, it pushes you a little extra further. Daigo was unable to confirm that crouching medium kick counter hit, but look at this Daigo with Tokido in the corner now. And again, you see he's ready for those anti-airs.
It was a very strong range that Daigo was hanging out with. He could harass the fireballs, no EX to keep it up. Overhead! 2-1. But I like the range where he was standing. He could throw fireballs pretty safely. There was no possibility of a jump in from that range. At least not that was massively preemptive.
Right. And again, like I said, Tokido has had the upper hand against Daigo much in their previous meetings, but it looks like Daigo has the upper hand right now. This man who says he's not prepared yet.
Right. He did say he's been traveling so much lately that he hasn't felt like he's been able to improve. Clearly, whatever level he's at is all right. Okay, got it. Not well. I think he just screwed up. Probably supposed to be stand short rather than down short. But I want to see a little bit of adaptation here from Tokido in terms of how he deals with Daigo. I'm not about to give him advice on it, but I'd love to see something.
Very even in life here. 60 seconds left on the clock. Oh, and there's a jump in. He's going to get good damage, not quite enough to kill. And oh, and now Tokido taking the round with an overhead.
Okay, nice.
I was about to say, he's not out of the water because Daigo had that full meter. He was going to be able to kill with one touch into a combo, into a super. But Tokido taking it with the overhead. Now, see him slowly walking Daigo into the corner.
Yes, harassing. Yes, there's the grab.
Doing a lot of extra damage thanks to that gray health.
Sweep, counter sweep. And then the patience allows Daigo to switch sides completely.
Ooh, Daigo went for a crouching strong anti-air.
Yeah, I wonder if that was supposed to be TP. I don't know.
It might have been an execution mistake, but right. it didn't come back to bite him that badly. Okay, Daigo spends a bar, so he doesn't have super anymore. Tokido, however, still sitting on a full meter.
Tokido trying to move forward. He did have the fireball. He chose not to super. He had it. Wow. Couple of chances, but hard to see. Tokido now trying to play patiently. Here's Daigo. Forward movement. Daigo, can he kip? No, he backed right off. Hit and run.
Tokido trying to throw that stunning light kick every once in a while, just in case Daigo dashes forward.
Oh, he's gonna be able to combo a stand light kick.
What?
The trigger in the super.
Amazing.
And Tokido's only reaction is to nod to himself, close his eyes, and go into perfect Zen mode.
Yes, ready.
Wow.
Very fitting, I think, that this kind of a set would go as far as it's going.
Fight.
It's 2-2.
Double throw.
Oh, the little bait. Here's Tokido. He did roundhouse, but right back in with another one. And then
that
the way.
Be a stun. And look at this, Tokido.
Everything's firing for him right now.
Taking huge command of this round. But Street Fighter V, the comebacks have been happening all weekend long. Tokido definitely not in the clear for this round just
yet. So far, can he make this comeback too? Oh, he wanted it.
Backdash from Tokido. Yeah, yeah, another throw attempt.
Okay, the knockdown. Daigo's, you gotta believe you can still do this. How many times have we seen this big comeback?
Oh, jumped in the air.
Oh,
that's punishable. Oh, wow, and look.
He really took a risk.
Look how close Daigo came for that comeback, but Tokido is the one at match point here.
Remember, this is loser's side. Who will be eliminated?
Oh, beautiful. Using the hurricane to go over fireball. Oh, baits it out. Big damage.
Look at all that red up there. And some orange, too. And that could have been it.
And that is going to be it. The stun. And now Daigo going to get his own big damage here. Spends the meter to try to finish him off. And then just goes for the axe kick. We're down to the last round. Last game once again here in top 8.
Oh, the backdash and Tokido with the down strong to interrupt another one.
Confirms it into the sandlight kick EX Hurricane.
His own stand short, very interesting little wheel of options after that neutral jump we've seen.
Yeah, that's the second time he's done that, with the empty jump sandlight kick.
Both really trying to counter poke here. Yeah, just in range for
just
it.
Just to push him into the corner.
Yeah, get the knockdown. Get this corner control. We've seen how well Daigo does once he's in here.
Oh, crash counter sweep. And he's going to back off and set it up. And yes, Daigo's going to jump and take the hit. And that's it. He's stunned.
Got to get it, though.
Can Tokido finish this off? It is. That's enough. And Tokido has eliminated Daigo Umehara. Daigo Umehara goes out here at CEO in fifth place. Tokido moves on and has once again defeated Daigo.
Amazing play. That was really just right down to the wire on both sides. And as good a display as you will see of how the same character can be used different ways by different people. Defensively, offensively, mid-range control, different pressure options, different reactions to very similar situations. A lot of that, you could really see the individual in it.
Right.
And that's something I love about fighting games. You could see the person playing. He doesn't even need to say Tokido up here.
Right.
But he doesn't need to see Infiltration Nash up here. You know it's Infiltration Nash. You know
exactly.
It's Tokido Ryu. That I love to see.
Yes, yeah. And like I said, the nice thing about, you know, Street Fighter V, it really does allow for a lot of expression through how you play the characters.
Strongly agree.
Yeah, most of the people who play the same characters play them in very different ways.
Yeah, for sure. Well, looks like we have another replay package ready to go. Let's check a look.
Yep, let's see how we've got to this point here at top 8. You see here, there's Haitani coming in. He started off in the winner's side, going up against Eiji Momochi. You see Eiji Momoji starting off. This is in the last game here. Getting right down there, and he finished it off with the perfect on the frame trap. Sending Haitani to losers. And Knuckledew, the last US player here in top eight, going up against Nuki. Well, wasn't feeling super confident in his anti-Chun Li game at first, but he came out like a bullet train and just took three games in a row over Nuki.
I thought that was very impressive.
Yeah.
Yeah, remaining, very, very impressive play. So he stays alive.
Yeah, remaining as the last U.S. player here. He is in loser's side. And I'm not sure which of the players that he's going to go up against. He's going to be going up against either Haitani. Oh, actually, Tokido just played Daigo, he is going to be going up against Haitani.
Correct. So, yeah, it's going to be Knuckledew Haitani. They've already lined up.
Yes.
Not just the last U.S. player, but the last North American player. Nobody here from Europe is in here. Shout out to that scene over there with Phenom having done so well just recently.
Yeah, exactly.
But some of their players came out here, and you know, East Asian scene tends to dominate here in North America.
Yeah.
And it's the same this weekend. But Dew is the remainder, the remaining defense.
That's right. And this is a tough one right here because Haitani, as we mentioned, one of the strongest players from Japan. A lot of the strongest players in Japan, I'm not just saying that from my own judgment,
yeah,
but the strongest players in Japan said that Haitani was the best Street Fighter V player at one point
right,
in time.
Right, we've heard that, sure, sure.
And so this is going to be a tough match here for Knuckledew. To have to be going up against Nikali. As you mentioned, he's going to be playing Nash, it sounds like, for most of this top eight.
Yeah, that's what he said. He said, unless something seems like it's going really wrong, he's just going to stick with Nash. And the Nash is great. You could see how strong it was against Nuki in the last set he played.
Using the knee to get past the Seismo. But again, you saw that how well that Crouch Strong worked as an anti-air for Nash against Chun-Li. But Nikali's neutral jump roundhouse just ate that for breakfast. Or I should say devour our is.
Yes. Air to air again.
That, yeah. Ooh!
No, he didn't get the cancel. That's waking up with buttons. That is some confidence right there.
Oh, and he's going to finish.
Why not? Oh, it could have been cool.
Wow, punched the wrong way. That's really unfortunate for Knuckledew. Beautiful stuff. It looked like he was doing that long walk into the throw. Instead, long walk, take a step back, watch that throw whiff, get the punish, that's the shimmy. Wow, did you see Knuckledew just staying aggressive after the block Sonic Sight?
Late on the hit there, I think he just didn't expect medium kick to hit.
Yeah, and right there, I don't think he was expecting that stand jab to hit after the dive kick.
Far away, trying to hit. Oh wow, really? A sweep at that range?
Both of them sitting on a lot of meter, but here comes Knuckledew. He gets a throw.
We're definitely seeing some good predictive stuff from Haitani against Knuckledew's Nash. I love he's been looking for the buttons that Dew has used.
Oh, and he got him with that. He's going to be able to go into the EX. Not quite enough to kill.
Oh, leaving Nikali alive with Super.
Into the hit, confirm, and Haitani is going to take game one. A couple of pixels away from taking that round was Knuckledew. But Haitani taking game one in this 3 out of 5 match.
Round one.
Here we go, game two.
There's the interrupt.
You know, that's
just love these buttons.
It's a very common tactic, you know, the empty jump into hit a button right when you land.
Yeah.
Because you no longer have the delay after you land if you empty jump. We saw,
again, that sweep. Again, predicting the bazooka knee. He's been right both times.
Okay, going to land on that. Try to juggle with the Sonic Side. Not quite in range.
I feel like it's so important for Dew to not corner himself in this matchup. Once you're there, it's just bad news.
Yeah, positioning, I feel like, is so important in Street Fighter V.
The double dash, the triple dash, I get it. I know he likes moving around, but he's put himself into the corner a couple times already, and that's been dangerous.
Double dash going up forward again. Nice! With the Sonic Sight there in the footsies, crouching strong. Oh, same mix-up again, and this time the combo is going to kill, and he doesn't even need the EX meter.
Round two. Fight.
Knuckledew's really had some interesting timings with that V-trigger mix-up.
Right through.
Yeah, using the armor.
Nice prediction. Wow, what a slow boom. You know, I think a lot of people would have expected that to be medium or the fast boom.
Yeah, against Nuki, Knuckledew has done that a bunch of times, a double dash into throw. It's like after the second dash, they're so worried about like the frame trap button.
We're seeing really some different timings from Knuckledew on the button choices from himself.
Nice,
some
gets
movement.
Under there.
He has super. Here's Nikali from Haitani.
That's definitely a win, getting him to spend it on a block.
Oh,
but this is a problem. He's just going to combo right in the super. He needs to make this comeback in this round. So all resources being spent right now.
Yeah, why not? He gets pressure.
Again, that meaty stand light kick.
Hey, nice work. Haitani turned it around just like that.
Yep. Final round. Of course, Knuckledew coming in here with a full bar. But again, meter built up really fast in this game.
Neutral jump over. And Duo, I wonder if the intention is to play more of a spot on screen rather than moving around. No, it seems like he's still intent on moving.
And you know what? I mean, look, Haitani is going to take that trade all day because every time he hits with that V skill, he's building his V trigger meter, which gives him chance to go into V trigger.
Here's the corner. Nice timing on the escape. Wow. Okay. That means we're ready for Super Saiyan. There he is.
Yeah, just activates it right away. He just wants the mobility now. See, look, he's willing to trade. He's going to do that all day. He has the life lead. There's no reason for him not to.
Nice work, that anti-air.
Oh,
and
Knuckle.
And Haitani has the proper counter. You know, you don't see that often, the jump forward on reaction to V-trigger.
Oh, what a dash forward. You see him get right under Knuckledew's move. And he's going to take game two now with that nice hit confirm. Haitani now on the verge of sending the U.S. last hope out of the tournament. Can Knuckledew make a comeback three games in a row?
And I wonder if there's going to be a change in character here. He did say he might go to Mika.
I would imagine at this point in time, I mean, I don't know how much Haitani and Fudo play against each other, but not going to be the situation.
What a start again with that sweep. It's a range where it's just nothing's going to happen unless Nash presses a button. And that is what happened. Nice punish there. Here's Knuckledew maybe trying conscientiously to be more offensive. That's unfortunate for him.
Yeah.
Haitani takes advantage.
Oh, okay. What a beautiful punish. That time baiting out the Seismo, and now Haitani goes for the wake up uppercut.
Dude trying to stay away, but again, here's this corner. Super, ready to go. In fact, even chip might be relevant at this point.
Right, and in fact, he might need to spend it just so he can.
Yeah, I mean, there's no view reversal on Haitani's side.
Oh, but the command throw at the one time that Knuckledew thought he was going to go for a button. The one time Knuckledew blocked, Haitani gets the EX command throw. He is at match point now. All right, so Knuckledew's going to spend some meter right away to keep Haitani out. Now you see Haitani's actually just reacting to the Sonic Boom animation. He's not even trying to predict to it to trade with the V skill.
He's not even getting involved in that. I feel like so many of the knockdowns have been him sticking out a button, and here's Duke sticking a button into it and getting hit.
Oh, big punish time. He's going to spend the meter. Yeah, get the damage now while he can. Get the life lead. Try to win this round and give him a round and a half to build all that meter back. There's a crush counter, tragedy assault.
That meter is no longer ready for super. Overhead, can there be a round? Okay, Samson's ready. And he hit. What a block!
What a block!
Super again! Haitani is a major threat at this point for Duo. Okay, plus, and of course, no view reversal.
Again,
really?
The block on the... Oh, it didn't punish! It didn't punish!
Hold on while I go to the frame data.
And that's huge because Haitani now goes in the last round with no meter. Was that supposed to be an EX uppercut maybe and it just came out as a super motion? Very unfortunate for Haitani now starting this round with no meter. But it's one of those situations, like I said, you can build meter pretty fast in this game, so I don't think Haitani is going to be too worried. And like I said, he's been winning a lot of this footsies match here.
Yeah, he's really done well for that.
No EX. Now remember the EX Sonic Scythe.
Oh no, KI mix-up. Reset.
Gets out of there. And no punish from Haitani. Oh, that crush counter sweep.
But again, it's that sweep at the same exact range. Very similar timing too.
And Knuckledew again backdashes himself into the corner, like you said. It's very dangerous.
Yeah, it's been happening.
Oh, yeah, no anti-air. Hasn't spent his meter for the EX Sonic side. Now, it is not truly in control. Oh, wow, a little too far.
Yeah, surprising to see that he would get baited to do that anti-air here from Duke. But he's playing with fire.
Oh, again. The neutral jump, and that's it. He has the super. That is going to be enough.
Congrats to Haitani. Moves on in loser's side. Knuckle Dew has been eliminated.
Haitani moving ahead. Of course, the crowd here very disappointed to see the last U.S. player sent home. But Knuckle Dew with a great run, getting his way through Nuki. Defeated a lot of strong players to make his make it all the way over here. Shout-outs to Knuckle Dew. Let's give another round of applause for Knuckle Dew for his awesome performance here at CEO 2016.
Nicely done. Nicely done.
All right. So that was one side of the loser's bracket. So now that means Haitani is going to be going up against Tokido. And they have not played each other at this event yet.
Okay.
So,
yeah, both started out winner's side top 8 mm-hmm, today.
Mm-hmm. So I believe, yeah. So, but we are actually not going to play that match
just yet.
We are actually going to move back to the winner's side, and we are going. I mean, look, these two guys have been super good in Street Fighter 4. They were like some of the best in Street Fighter 4.
Yeah, yeah.
And here they are again.
They're on the short list of the greatest all-time Street Fighter 4 players, of course.
Mm-hmm. And no shock that they're here again. That's Infiltration and Momochi going up against each other here in Winners Finals. As I mentioned before, Momochi has defeated Infiltration recently. So he's kind of had the upper hand. But, you know, even though we mentioned that we have seen a little bit of the cracks from Infiltration, he still looked pretty solid against Tokido, and he won that 3-1.
Yeah.
So, you know, maybe when it comes to Capcom Premier events, Infiltration just turns it on. Now, keep in mind here, remember they changed the rules here for the Capcom Pro Tour. If a person wins a Premier event more than once, that spot doesn't go to the second place person. That spot gets eliminated
mm-hmm.
and gets turned into a points position. Infiltration has already taken out the NorCal regional spot. He won 2 events in a row. He qualified at final round.
Exactly.
And then he took out the NCR spot. And here he is with the potential to take out the CEO spot and turn that into a points position as well.
Uh-huh.
Handshake between the two players. And it is going to be Nash versus Ken, as we expected.
By the way, just did the research, and Nakali Super does not punish that overhead from Nash.
Okay.
So it probably was an EX DP he was looking for,
right,
or regular DP something.
It happens sometimes, like if you're crouching and then you go for the uppercut and it comes out as a super.
Round one.
Super has higher priority, so even if you hit two buttons, it comes out as a super anyway.
Oh yeah, other people just texted me that too. Shout out to you. So winners finals. And here's that, you know, it's a similar style. I feel like Dew wants to play what Infiltration is playing right now. It's just, it seems so strong. Infiltration is so good at not being within his opponent's buttons and seemingly always being within his own. Right, that combination is not easy to make happen. Okay. Hurricane Kick does the trick. Here's Momochi into the corner. There's no V reversal. There's no V trigger for Nash. Oh, looking for big stuff.
Oh,
and
just overhead.
All right, man.
Oh,
we just found out it's minus 6, so it's pretty punishable by Ken.
Oh, nice delay there. Gets a throw. Ooh, Momochi not taking the bait. Look at that. Look at the defense. Just blocked. A long sequence there from Infiltration, not touching a button again. Infiltration's got to go for the throw at some point in time, otherwise
you
there's
would
really
think,
no
right?
reason for Momochi to. Oh, and then Momochi takes it with the frame trap.
Round two. Fight.
The distance game by Infiltration coming in for forward fierce. And just like that, he's back to this distance game. Momochi, though, I really like the approach. Yes. I like the jump timings. I was just going to say he's threatening with an EX dive kick. Knockdown. And are we back to the distance or no? It's really more mid-range harassment right now. Orange's melt is really adding up. We used too far. Stun happens anyway. Infiltration takes the round.
Gonna do so by stealing a little meter. He actually didn't have a full bar until that connected. So he's coming into this round now with a full bar. Beautiful. Using his meter to basically nullify and make Momochi waste his meter. Wow, Momochi challenging with the back medium punch target combo. Nice punish.
Jumping right over.
The air to air.
Yeah, so important to have different tools. That point, if Infiltration had gone for that air-to-air again, he probably would have been hit in the air. So again, important to have different tools and know when to bring them out.
But now Momochi sitting. Oh, what? He just walked into it. He just walked into it. I'm not sure what he thought. I mean, it's not like he has an air hurricane or anything like that, but he just ended up just a misjudge on the distance there. We've seen that a couple of times now. Definitely when Momochi was fighting against Haitani, it just looked like it was the uppercuts were coming out a little too late. But that time, that was a distinct walk forward into the jumping attack. Just really thought Momochi thought that the jump was going to go further.
Not too much Nash can do to that step kick in that situation.
Momochi now trying to poke, it looks like, with that standing medium punch. And Infiltration busting out a different anti-air.
And now he busted through an EX too, I think. That's doubly costly for Infiltration. Neutral jump, 8K. All the tools.
That's like the fourth or fifth anti-air we've seen him use so far. Sitting on a full V-trigger.
The overhead, again, in just such unusual situations. Nobody else uses them there. And he's back playing away. Momochi is very dangerous right now. If he can find a hit, well, really, I mean, he's two hits away from ceiling. If he can find the right two hits. Okay, there's one. Is it? Ah, a jab. But he was close.
Round two. Fight.
All right. Gets the target combo, spins the meter to get that corner carry. Good defense this time from Infiltration, but now Momochi getting in. Stun is an issue. Tries to get out of there. Ooh, tried to punish.
Oh, what a delay. Nice. Momochi gets the hit. He is trying to stun as well.
Yeah, but you see right there, Infiltration actually reacting to the back strong with his own stand jab.
Roundhouse?
Wake up, Roundhouse. Sure. Let's do it. Let's do it.
You can't criticize him. What are you going to say? Nobody can say anything.
Exactly.
Here's the grab.
Try to hit him, but a back dash will escape that standing round. Oh, what an air throw!
Now, it's a costly air throw. And so for Momochi, he might be happy about it, but is he going to lose because of that air throw? Do you think he's going to die because he took that air throw?
Ooh, it's not quite enough yet!
Amazing. So close. Where is it going to be? And he hit
and
the
he
overhead!
Did go for the... It was like it was the so obvious choice that it became the sneaky choice. That's exactly what happened. Momochi was like, he is trying to hit me. You saw the two low shorts. And then he went for the overhead, and Momochi just didn't believe he was going to go for the clear overhead that everyone goes for at the end of rounds.
Yep. He did have a fake with the crouching shorts. But again, his overhead timings are just so weird that you almost don't expect him to do the normal stuff.
Right. Nice whiff punish with his own stand roundhouse.
Yeah, just because other people see that overhead coming, just because you might be looking for it, doesn't mean you would look for it in that situation. Or, more importantly, that Infiltration would use it against you in that situation
right,
when he thinks you're expecting it.
It's always interesting, but if you were put in that exact same situation as another player, all the information that came before it is completely different.
All right, medium kick starts things off here, Momochi.
No punish on the whip throw.
He's standing just outside, and I like the range, but what's he going to get there?
You see... Infiltration throwing out that crouching medium kick four times in a row.
Right. I mean, and what's Ken going to do? He just, as good as I think Ken is, he doesn't have that tool, right? He doesn't have that footsie tool.
Oh, nice. Dash forward over the to punish the neutral jump. Gets right back in there with the moonsault slash.
Absorbed. Giving him V reversal.
Oh, that's punishable. Yeah. Mochi trying to fish in there, trying to get in, but a forward dash from Infiltration catching Momochi off guard.
Momochi's just trying to chase. That's his goal right now. He has V-Trigger ready. Oh! Oh! If he had continued!
Okay. Oh, just gets out of there. And Momochi wanted to punish it with the uppercut, but it was too far.
I wonder if that was an intentional uppercut or a fireball. I just don't know. So we have match point for infiltration. He is making quick work of one of the best players in the world in Momochi. And he's threatening to get to the grand finals of yet another premier event on the Capcom Pro Tour. Pressure attempt from Momochi, neutralized. And infiltration, just like that, is right back to the ice skate. Slipping around here and there.
Okay, here we go, confirm. Gonna get a good chunk of damage. And keep the corner position. What a block on that empty jump. And he's going to get the roundhouse.
No. He wanted more. Still wants more. Oh. Again, he's getting more. Can he seal it? Anti-air down strong does. And that means infiltration moves to grand finals. To nobody's surprise, including, clearly, his own. As he walks off under complete power as if nothing crazy had just happened at all.
And as we mentioned earlier today, showing no cracks at all in his gameplay, Dominic.
Look, it seemed like it in previous events.
Yeah, no, it did. It did. Like I said, he was defeated by Momochi at a couple of events. But right now, infiltration just looks like when it's time, like when the premier events are on the line. I mean, at this rate, is he going to win every single premier event that's in North America?
Yeah, as you said, that has really big consequences for how the CPT works.
Right. That's,
I don't know. I
mean, he's on the road right now. He's in grand finals. He's going to be waiting whoever comes out of loser's bracket between Momochi, Tokido, and Haitani.
Yeah, yeah. And that's quite a list. If there's ever anybody who's going to take him out, it, you know, it could be one of those three. That's as good a list as any for sure.
So there you go. This is the loser's semis. Tokido going up against Haitani. I mean, you know, It's one of those situations. I think I made this comparison before in a different situation. Obscure movie reference here, but right now Tokido has got to feel like Solieri and infiltration's got to be his Mozart. You know, he's just sitting there and like he's everything he does, he keeps getting upstaged by infiltration because seriously, Tokido has finished second, third, and all this stuff. And all everyone's doing is just talking about how infiltration is dominating everybody.
Well, look, for Haitani, it's similar. How many times has he gotten top eight at a big event so far?
Right.
He is consistently getting deep into these tournaments. And yet when it comes down to it, it's infiltration. Mm-hmm. Just amazing play. And it seems to me as well, thinking back on some of those rounds infiltration had, I guess I felt as if Momochi had some of those rounds, right? They Momochi rounds. And I have to really think about it to play back in my mind exactly when Nash did enough damage, like when he did 1,000 damage, right, to kill Ken, which is what you need to do. When did that happen? But it happened a lot more than the other way happened, that's for sure.
Again, this is loser semis. This is for fourth place. Whoever loses this gets fourth place. The winner of this gets to loser's finals against Momochi.
We're going to see more Nikali. We're going to see more Ryu. We'll see what they have to say about each other.
Round one. Fight.
I really like this matchup. You know, I've played it a bit from the Ryu side, and I always feel like it's really fun. Bunch of interesting mid-range tools, bunch of interesting mobility tools, a lot of damage on both sides. It can be dangerous.
Interesting. Haitani playing that stay-away game right now. Seems like he says, you know what, Tokido, if you're willing to stay on the other side, I will as well. And that way, I can build some V-skill meter.
He got a little greedy there with the stand roundhouse rather than just sweeping out. Okay, air-to-air is paying off. And all of those V-skills, I should say, are what made that work.
Right.
So Samson pops up again. Pair of flowing.
No uppercut. Oh, that's going to be counterable right there.
Again, Tokido fishing with that stand roundhouse, but Haitani with a nice whiff punish on it.
You know, Haitani just feels like he's playing comfortably. He's either far away or... Oh, yeah, the stand short attempt.
Yeah, he could have punished that. Didn't quite get it in time. Nice stand jab anti-air. Of course, Nikali with that ridiculously amazing stand jab anti-air.
I felt like Haitani was comfortable playing afar, like he was comfortable playing up close. The dreadlocks are back on. Interrupted. Oh, and Tokido with the interrupt of his own. Saves the bar, trying to set something up, but Haitani's seen it before. Now here in the corner. Big stun. Tokido, he didn't quite build super. He's getting close. And here he comes.
So the question is he... Oh, no, he's not going to save it. He's just going to spend it. And, you know, that was the kind of situation. The reason why he spent it there is because if it was blocked, he would have did an uppercut in the super and might have been able to kill him through chip damage as well. So he was going to cancel that in the super no matter what.
Yeah, I think you're right. This distance game. Nice. What a read there. EX just to make sure he could deal some damage. For Haitani, the goal of building up V-Trigger as fast as possible. Oh, well, hey, you know what? Still working. You're still getting red if you're getting hit.
Right. Oh, wow. Was that a punish? Because, I mean, he
counter
just went
hit.
Right with a hurricane.
Tokido, no anti-air, but he has corner at least for himself. Right, will he spend bar? Not
yet. He's not going to spend it. Wow. Walks in for the frame trap, but nice block. Nice patience from Tokido. Again, no uppercut from Tokido.
This pressure series, that's a lot of great damage lost. Super still ready. I don't think Tokido's going to take a risk on the fireball. And very patient.
Oh, what a jump in. There it is. Into the super. And Tokido's going to take the game number one.
Tokido had played so patiently in a lot of the situations. There have been so few jumps toward. He mentioned this when he played against Daigo. Same ending to that game as the first game of that set.
Now, it's interesting because I know I've said this at another event. I don't remember which one, but Tokido, remember, he was always about playing like the most dirty things. He created the Akuma Vortex, aka the Tokido Shiki, named after him in Japan. And his footsie game was something that he really recently kind of really honed in, right? But what's interesting to me about that is I feel like you can see it because he gets jumped in on a lot than most players. Like as Ryu, he doesn't uppercut anti-air as much.
That's so good. You know that Nikali's looking for the counter hit combo after down strong. Right.
Oh, perfect timing. And he gets the stun, builds some meter. Just goes for the simple three hitter and he takes that round.
He had that set up three times. One time we've seen Haitani crouching jab. One time we've seen the low short from Tokido. And that time we saw TP get blocked. So it seems like a nice situation for Ryu. But there are counters, of course. Haitani now, he was trying to pressure. Right back into doing so. Sweep! A little too far. A little too late, maybe, really, than it was. The sweep trying to get things started.
Interesting.
Gotta make it big. Yes.
Oh, look at all that damage. But of course.
Oh, jump fierce!
Again!
That huge hand stretching out to the dome of Ryu.
So before Momochi was getting caught by that without the uppercut, now here we see Tokido. Like I said, it's interesting as a Ryu player, like I feel like he gets jumped in on more than other Ryus. He seems to have that focusing on the ground game, so he's not thinking about the anti-airs as much.
I love that conversion. Stand short, EX.
Yeah.
Ooh, nice button timing.
Yeah.
Knowing exactly when to take up that space. Dive kick trying to get through is a good idea. Beat trigger's almost ready for Nikali.
I mean, it's interesting. Nikali, he's punishing with the EX stomp, but...
That's not easy. Dashing forward.
Oh, wow, a jump back. He's going to take it with the air-to-air.
But Tokido has a lot of damage up above himself.
Again,
and he's going to steal it.
Again, the same way with that one crucial jump at the end of the game. How many rounds did he took one round from Daigo that way, and now that's the second time he's done it to Haitani.
Yeah, he's 2-0 in this set, in part because of that.
Wow.
Round one. Fight.
Slowly moving. Yeah. And you see how much that builds down there on the bottom left. Already there's a bar of the V-meter. Jump roundhouse counts. This character really has some of the better jump era buttons in the game. Tokido trying to fight. Into the corner now is Haitani. Oh, his own jump.
Yeah, that time he got, now he's got the big damage. And he gets the frame trap as well. Tokido definitely not out of this. If you remember, I believe it was that final round where Tokido made the ridiculous comeback against Haitani with the double back roundhouse light kick hurricane combos.
Look at that mobility on Nikali's side. He can be in or out whenever he wants.
Ooh, but he gets him with the ground pound. All right, so Haitani trying to stay alive here. Needs to win three games in a row. But you know what? You take it one round at a time, and that's the first round for Haitani. And Haitani, obviously, the kind of caliber player who can do this, but Tokido gets a jump in.
Yeah, very good use of jump short to hit towards the ground faster.
See how when Tokido gets hit by the ground pound, does a quick rise and immediately forward dashes.
It's all about taking all the space you can. You know, moving as quickly as you can. Didn't want to take a risk on the DP. Looked like, I think he jumped on reaction. And now they both have super. Here comes Super Saiyan Nikali. Here comes Samson. Into the corner. Big start. Could have been anyway.
I think he thought he was too far to get anything off of that.
Did you see those huge throw whiffs? Not punished? The reversal for Tokido settles things back down.
Careful of the chip.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. You're right. It's a possibility.
That could have been it right there.
You're right.
He wants to save the meter for the next round.
I think that's ideal for him, but we'll see if he goes for it. Ooh. There's no view reversal, of course, from Nikali when he's in trigger.
And now Nikali with all that meter. Tokido just take this round with a super, maybe? No, he does it with the throw. He gets it. And he gets to save all that meter. A huge gamble by Tokido, but he's willing to take it, especially maybe in the situation where he's up 2 games to nothing.
Try to get big stuff. And just a couple of frames away from doing so, that crouching jab from Nikali was susceptible to it. Punish. Interesting choice. Neutral jump. I think that's the first time that's been tried by Haitani. Match point, Tokido.
And sitting on all that bar. Look at that. Haitani spending it on the EX stomps. He's been doing that a lot. I was about to mention that earlier when he does low forward EX stomp to punish Tokido's sweep.
No super.
I feel like that's kind of made it so that Haitani's had a harder time with comeback factor. And that should do it right there into the super. Tokido is going to send Haitani home with a 3-0 domination.
Wow. That was, yeah, absolute domination. And, you know, Haitani certainly was fighting there. 3-0, maybe not quite as lopsided as it seemed at the time. But in each of those big, important moments, Tokido made the choice he needed to make. The jumps that sealed two of those three, for example. Big stuff by Tokido. Looking good. I mean, he has seemed to me like he is consistently sort of either the best or the second best at every event he goes to.
Right. Right. But again, this top eight has been ridiculous. Let's take a look at some of the replays of what happened earlier in the evening.
Yeah, it's been a good one so far. We're going to check out Infiltration versus Momochi. Yeah, that was the air throw, remember?
Right. After he baited him and then he V-triggered over, caught him out of that, and then was able to combo into the super. Wasn't quite enough to kill.
Yeah, but look at this.
Right,
the little harassment, right? Short, overhead. And I feel every viewer at that point said, really?
Yeah, he really did the overhead?
He really got hit by the overhead, but...
Oh, yeah. Okay. I see what you're saying.
But it's in part because it's so obvious that it doesn't work. You're right to point that out. Mm-hmm. So Infiltration looking dominant. There's one of those big jumps.
I mean, 2 games that he was able to take with that.
There's one of those big jumps.
Yeah, there it is. And again, like I said, 2 games, that's what got him up 2-0.
Right.
And then this was the crucial round right here. Tokido saving that meter, getting that throw. And you know, that gamble paid off for him because how did he kill Haitani in the very last round?
Exactly, yeah. Jump in, super.
Boom, and there it was.
So Tokido's looking good. He really
is. Oh, yeah. But you know what? He's got a tough one coming up for him. in losers finals, Tokido going up against Eiji Momochi. This is for third place. The loser gets third place. The winner gets to go up against Infiltration, and you know Tokido wants to get back up there
to try to fight him again.
Yep. But you know what? Momochi wants that run back just the same. Both of them sent to loser's bracket by Infiltration.
Exactly.
Both of these guys want that revenge chance.
We're going to have a Ken versus Ryu battle.
Classic fight.
Yeah, but I really like how in this game they've differentiated them even more. This is the most different they've ever been.
Yeah. Like, they're normal. They don't even have, like, share any normals.
Yeah, very few, I think, yeah. Yeah, I really like how they've done it. And they've really defined Ken as being more about the pressure. Ryu can do that too, but he's much more all around, and that's Ryu. So I like what they've done.
The interesting thing about the situation is that if Momochi wins this, the premier spot is guaranteed to be gone. Momochi won Stunfest.
You're right.
So right now, the only person who can qualify for the Capcom Cup right now is Tokido. If he can win these two matches in a row.
Yeah, against Momochi and then Infiltration, so it's not going to be easy to do. He's fighting from the corner. He tried to walk up, but it was just too far on the grab. Love the punish.
Yeah,
and he's still caught there. Look at this corner pressure from Momochi.
Okay,
finally,
okay.
Tokido with...
Ooh, and the one time he does an uppercut, and Momochi gets to cross the
finally,
hurricane.
Though, Tokido's out of there. He can still make this happen.
Yeah,
it's not over. It's not over. Pressure! Oh. Momochi playing patiently. The grab whiff again. How many times? Patience on Momochi's side.
Oh, he gets out of there.
No whiff punish. Tokido fishing. He's going to look for the stab at some point, and Momochi knows that. Momochi's playing defensively and patiently as a result.
Oh, and there it is, the fireball from Momochi. Caught Tokido by surprise at that one moment that he was going to walk forward. That's what Momochi was hoping for, trying to fish with that fireball. Remember, the fireball is just another poke. It's just another poke that keeps traveling forward. Momochi using it right there, the very moment that Tokido took a step forward. Oh, he tried to parry the air hurricane? Didn't pay off.
Right. Buttons, yeah, well, all right. Got a little punish on that. Stand short, spin cancel.
Spends the meter on the EX fireball to get the knockdown in a little bit more position. Hoping to get that bar back. I mean, he definitely will get the bar back before the round ends.
Like these little buttons from Tokido, taking up space. I feel like that's one of the strengths Ryu has in this matchup. It's more credible there, but nice jump.
Yeah, because he knows that stand light kick in the fireball is susceptible to that.
Not punished super terribly. Momochi, okay position still. Tokido saving it. Could have done super, but yeah, just saving it. Here comes Momochi, and Tokido's not going to get the chance. It always feels like you're just a couple of hits away from losing against Ken.
Yeah.
You just, even though he doesn't have those buttons like Ryu does, like, you know, other characters even better, you just always know that you are a mistake away from being one mix-up away from dying.
Right. And that is the power of Ken right
there. It's dangerous. It really is. It makes the opponents think twice about a lot of different actions. Here comes Tokido getting big stuff. Looked like that was out of the air. Backlash, maybe. Corner pressure now, Tokido. What can he make happen? Patience on Momochi's side. Is he? Just like that. Went from
sneaks
patience
it in there, yeah.
To not at all.
And with the back throw, switching the sides, so important for Momochi.
I think that's the first run grab that we've seen work like that. Button run grab.
Another run up throw. And again, another throw. Oh, try to bait him out, but good patience from Tokido. Not hitting any buttons, not going for the throw.
Mm-hmm, okay, the trigger. Yeah, try to get away. Look at that standing around. Look at that. The mixing up.
Oh wow.
Tokido stays alive.
And he can combo that. He can combo that. He can confirm it. And there it is. He's going to take that round. Tokido just snatching that round.
Round two.
I thought he was pretty much done. He had the bad positioning, but then managed to get one hit in there and was able to confirm off of the fireball into the super. And that's the advantage of having that low forward fireball. You know, you can see it and then confirm into the super.
Yeah.
And great stuff on Tokido to have the awareness to just go for that in that moment.
Again, lots of harassing. That's really, you know, that's Ken's tool. Stand around house. Making a count. looking for the confirms. Yep, had to make it safe right there. That chain by itself is not.
Nice confirm, yeah. Gets the combo into the EX Hurricane, pushes himself out of the corner a little bit too. All that space is key. Oh wow! Tokido maybe was expecting the second kick.
Yeah,
oh, nice. That's a confirm. That should be able to take it for Momochi. There it is. Tying this game up to one round apiece. And again, you know, the thing that I always like to look at the start of the third round is the resources. They are at the exact same meter resource right
here
now.
Here comes Ken. Yeah, interrupted that time. I'm surprised to see him try it again. I guess it worked once. Why not a second time? But
great autocorrect DP, and here comes...
Again?
Okay, that should be punished. Yep, there it is. Now Tokido goes for the throw in the corner. Oh, fake the throw.
Yeah, tried to escape. That was let go before. The backdash! Look at that perfect timing. Stunt, just like that. This should be the game. Tokido, maybe not.
Oh, he didn't use any meter for that.
I'm very surprised.
Why he not use any meter for that? And here comes Momochi. He gets the throw. He tries to get it for another.
Super's
okay, there it is. Wait, he has the reversal.
So.
He has the B reversal.
I don't think so.
And now, Tokido with no meter. Here comes Momochi. Gets the throw.
Momochi is so dangerous right now. He's so dangerous. Can he make it happen?
Oh, a great tech from Tokido.
Tokido just needs anything.
Oh no!
Anything!
Oh, but a dash throw!
Can he get anything?
And the shimmy is gonna do it for Momochi! The heart beating for Tokido! And Momochi with that huge comeback!
If it had been EX Dragon Punch, James.
Right?
That's all right? I'm thinking about right now.
In that combo.
That's all I'm thinking about right now. Wow. Well, in any case, Tokido's gonna have to try to recover from that. Momochi running up, getting the grab.
That's gotta be a heartbreaker, but can Tokido recover from this? He's down 2-0, but a great start here in game number 3.
Trying to fish around, both of them now.
Okay. Dashing up, gets the back throw, but gonna convert into that.
Nice, and the corner carrier.
Dude, look how far that takes and the damage, and here comes Momochi. This is where he stole the game right from Tokido. And nice, a forward jump throw OS tech. Back dash to escape the throw. Ooh, trade. And Momochi slowly but surely catching
up. Tried to get it, no dice.
Yeah. Oh, crush counter, but no run cancel off of that. Usually you can kind of confirm that on a crush counter hit.
You can OS it.
Oh, try to bait something else. That just goes for the overhead.
Well, that for Tokido, this needs to be the start of things. This needs to be start of a change. And it's hard to play against the way that Momochi is playing, which is to get into a range where back strong is relevant as Ken. Just outside of that, he's doing things like stand roundhouse that, you know, it's not the best, but it takes up space. Important space. Yeah, there's that space that, yeah.
Okay, that time Tokido properly challenged
a lot of the
standing medium kick.
Here, people do medium kick and then they try another crouching strong, but that's not real. And I like that Tokido blows it up.
Yeah, he got hit by it earlier, so now he's kind of more aware of it, it looks like. Yeah, because the second hit of that target combo doesn't even hit crouching characters.
Right. Nice.
Confirm. Honestly, right now. Oh, wow. Did you see how far he walked forward to get that autocorrect uppercut? Now back in the corner. Here we go.
Momochi cannot be underestimated. That is for sure. Last game
demonstrated
that.
Look at all that meter that Momochi has. Oh, but he dashes in to Tokido standing light kick. Then, of course, Tokido canceling it into an EX Hurricane no matter what.
Right, just doing that motion.
Right, just doing it, and only if it hits does that actually come out.
Exactly
so
right.
If no dash forward happened, you just get a whiff light kick and nothing happens. So that's that button OS tech.
Well, I'm glad to see Tokido trying to make the recovery, the brain fart of Fierce DP and not EX DP. That damage differential is, I think, 20. It's not that big of a deal, but that could have been it. So to recover from that is an important sign.
Right. Exactly. That is one of the things that, you know, we talk about a lot in Street Fighter, the mental fortitude.
Yes.
Street Fighter is so, I mean,
we talk about obviously the mental side from strategy and everything like that, but you cannot underestimate the emotions, the fatigue, the self-doubt. Gets the sweep.
Stabbing his way in there. Very little in the way of zoning. It's just not that viable against Ken. So instead, you see a lot of this mid-range stuff, but here's pressure.
And there's, again, another key jump in from Tokido. He has had, that's the fourth one we've seen all day, and Tokido is trying to bring this back all the way from being down 0-2. If he can take one more round, he's going to tie it up at 2-2. It's all he needs is one more round. Whoa, double sweep.
Moving forward into an interesting range. I really like Momochi's willingness to just walk up. Walk up, try back strong, see what happens.
Yeah, again, see, there's that proper challenge off the stand mini again. You saw it right there. He went for the second one. Oh, and Tokido now finally gets that anti-air uppercut.
Some important fireballs right there. Yes, and again.
Tokido is looking so solid.
Yeah.
Oh, and again, that jump in.
Again. Again.
And look at that. He used the EX meter that time.
Well, good man.
Said, I'm not making that same mistake again. And just like that, Tokido ties it up 2-2. We are going down to the last game between these two titans. And who will get a chance to go up against Infiltration again?
And as you said, if Momochi wins, that means that the final two in the Grand Finals have already qualified via winning premieres. If Tokido wins, he can still auto-qualify if he takes this tournament. So that's part of what's on the line as well.
That was number six right there of Tokido. Beautiful jump timing.
And the stun.
Oh, and there it is. The stun, and Tokido is going to get to match point via a perfect maybe? Oh, no,
again.
Not quite.
Please, Tokido, no. Tokido, no. Momochi, can he do it again?
Oh,
no.
Not that time. Not that time.
Again, 20 damage is usually not that big of a deal, but there was a pixel remaining. It would have done the trick.
And now Tokido at match point. Okay, not uppercutting the jump. Okay, beautiful whiff punish. And a wake up uppercut from Momochi is going to put Tokido into the corner. Tokido got to find a way out of here, but Momochi, you see him back off to make sure that he doesn't get a chance to jump over him. And now here comes the pressure from Momochi.
Pressuring well. The fierce.
Just eats the jump fierce close to stun.
Dudley jump roundhouse works really okay.
And that's, you know what, that's a call out. That's a call out to the shimmy tech right there. You catch the walk back.
And he got the hit. I wonder what Tokido was looking for. I don't know. But either way, we are going to the last round in this set.
Ladies and gentlemen, buckle up. Here we go. Last round.
Momochi trying to move forward. No. Backs off. Tokido, pressure of his own. Super gone.
Oh, wow. Challenge. Just caught him with the back strong. And now into the corner. Thunder kick. Catching him overhead.
Interrupted.
And he gets out, but beautiful. Auto-correct uppercut from Momochi. Oh, and Tokido punishing the EX dive from the ground again. Another punish. Oh, he's got the combo. Is he going to confirm? No, he goes for the EX fireball.
I think that's all right. He needs some bar.
Oh, fancy times.
Can he get the stun? If so, no. Yeah, I really like that. To interrupt it. And he can still take this. Either way,
and
that is
going to
be it. That's going to be it. Tokido seals the deal. Three games to two.
The same way that Daigo defeated Mago came down to that one wake-up uppercut. Tokido blocks it, and he is able to defeat Momochi. And now Tokido is the man who has the right to challenge Infiltration once again.
What a comeback from Tokido.
And
it's not just that he came back down from games. It's that he came back down from having made a major mistake in being able to take a game and just doing the wrong thing.
One round at a time. One round at a time.
Yeah.
That is how Tokido played that, and he played it beautifully. Down 0-2, takes it 3-2.
Yeah, it's been amazing, and it's been a good top eight in general, right?
Dude, can I just do...
I hear you. I hear you. Let's go back and take a look at some more of the replays that we've been seeing.
Man,
get a little bit of a secondary take on this
Momochi Tokido.
Yeah, and there it was, Momochi starting off very strong, taking that first game pretty convincingly over Tokido. And then here we go, here's the second game.
Yeah.
This is that situation where I think this is where Tokido, if he had just used the EX uppercut.
Oh, no.
This is just the super fireball, yeah, that he was able to confirm. But here it is.
Look at this. Look at that. Look at that.
Was that even 20 health?
I don't even think that was fierce. That looked like it was jab.
Yeah. And now here comes Momochi.
Definitely a big error.
And V reversal right through there. And then he gets the throw. All of us would be devastated at that point, and there's no coming back.
Right. It's just tough mentally.
Right. But the fact that Tokido came back with some of these beautiful jump-ins over the fireball, and look at that fate. Look at that. Oh, man.
It's so difficult to get a jump on a top-level player. You have to make them pay attention to the ground way more than they'd like to, so that they just aren't paying attention to the air as much. And he was able to do that.
And then here we go. Momochi taking it to the last round, and then there it is, Tokido with the fancy combos.
I love this view reversal.
And
I love this view reversal because he knows everything's riding on that. He just could not get out of the situation. Certainly, I like Momochi's attempt to turn it in his favor with the view trigger activation. He would be, he'd have the big time advantage on block if there was no view reversal.
Right.
So smart, but from Tokido, very smart play to turn it around just as fast. So we move now to Grand Finals.
Again, we started the top eight with Tokido versus Infiltration. We are ending it with Tokido versus Infiltration here at CEO 2016.
And it's the way that two other premieres have ended so far, right?
No question.
Final
round, these are the two best right now.
It seems that way. Final round ended like this, and Infiltration won it. NorCal Regionals ended like this, and Infiltration won it. And then, as you said, they played earlier today. Infiltration won it. That was 3-1. So we'll see what Tokido can do, see if he can relax himself enough. Of course, he has to win 2 3 out of 5 sets to take this whole tournament.
And look at that. Infiltration starting off smooth as butter, just like that. Beautiful distancing, getting that whiff punish on the crouch roundhouse. Wow. It feels like it's just a different person. Like, you see Tokido able to, like, kind of grind it out against all those other players, just like this, brawl, but all of a sudden, Infiltration is just, he looks so clean.
Yeah, we've seen Tokido try to play, we've seen him try to play against characters he needs to run in on, and he's had success, right? We've seen that. We've seen him play well against people who want to run in on him, but there's just something about Infiltration's slippery style that seems like it solves everybody. The block this time, and the punish.
Okay.
The low, super, no, saved. And can he get something else?
Gets a throw now, for sure, a combo into super will kill. Oh!
He did an anti-air? Infiltration knows all he needs is one hit. And it can be anything.
And you see how he staggered
the
timing just a tiny bit that time. Low short, wait, overhead. Beautiful timing from Infiltration, takes that first round. Okay.
Nice moves, yes, and he maintains corner control without doing medium or roundhouse.
To stun. Did he?
No way!
Tokido says, get that weak stuff out of here! And Tokido!
Oh my god, I can't believe he parried it on reaction! And then he did the maximum possible damage after that. That's somebody who is coming into these grand finals with a purpose. Amazing.
Oh, and he gets the throw bait. He's trying to do it again, but look at that patience from Infiltration. Infiltration's defense so strong. All that work, and Tokido is tied in health, basically.
Again, try to think about the fact that he has to take down 1,000 life on Ryu. Where's that coming from? It's individual hits.
Right.
Almost all individual hits.
Ooh, chases down the back dash with the stand roundhouse. Wow. He went for the empty jump and Infiltration challenge with the stand light punch.
Yeah, we saw Haitani blow that up with crouching jab, but there's stand jab from Nash.
Okay, and now Infiltration showing the throw card.
Super's ready.
Oh,
that should be. Really? Well, Infiltration coming in. EX a couple of times.
Overhead again!
Of course it's overhead.
How many rounds has Infiltration taken via overhead?
Of course it's overhead. What else would it be? But don't look at that and think, whoa, I would have blocked that overhead again. Two things. One, nah, probably not. Two, somebody like Infiltration is only picking the moves that he thinks are going to work against the particular person he's playing against at the time. Look, and if you're an overhead blocker, hey, guess what? That would have been down short.
Look, I'm telling you right now, it's easy for us to sit here and go, I would have blocked that while we are under no pressure and just sitting here in our, you know,
watching. Yeah, man, we got the easy job. There's no doubt.
When you're in that moment and you are, and your heart is beating and that adrenaline is flowing, man. Oh, nice, just using that knee. I mean, we've seen Infiltration do that a lot. Use the knee just to escape those jump situations. Nash doesn't have a perfect anti-air. Sometimes he'll just do that. Oh, that time, the jump OS, anti-jump OS tech worked.
Round two, fight.
Okay, the backdash for Infiltration. Still maintaining that slippery play. The jump perfectly placed, and there's a bunch of red at once. Too early. Huh? Also too late.
Oh man, these footsies from Infiltration are ridiculous. Okay, standing light kick, punishing that crouching medium kick. That might actually be good information for Tokido.
Oh, I'm sure he knows about that. It's an important tool. It's just that typically...
Oh,
well, he could have gotten bigger stuff, but I think he just didn't need it. He thought he didn't need it, I should say.
How many rounds is Infiltration going to take with an overhead?
I hope it's everyone. Why not?
At this point in time, I mean, it might as well be. Now it's like a mission.
Right? Yeah. How can I do this?
Like, achievement unlocked.
Yeah. No,
oh,
the parry was not good.
Punishing the parry, yeah.
And there are many times when Infiltration throws the boom and he doesn't come in, right? So the parry seems like it's reasonable, but it's at, of course, the time when Tokido tries to parry that Infiltration comes in.
Okay, he gets the... Oh, he's going for it.
Great. This is way reduced, but it's pretty sick anyway.
Oh, he's going to save the meter. Interesting. Okay. Oh, he went for it. He wanted to get the short hurricane combo into super. Good block. Infiltration actually did that. Teleport a little too late. Here comes Tokido. He has a life lead. Can he get the autocorrect uppercut? He does.
Can he get a game? Can he get a game? Don't count Infiltration's harassment out. He can definitely make this work. What is it going to be? The late...
The stand light kick is going to do it. I'm sorry, Tokido now taking one game.
You win.
Remember, he did take one game in winner's side.
Yes,
that
it was 3-1.
Three to one. Yeah.
See part of the crowd right there. Yep, they're ready to go. Tokido took a little bit of time on the left side of your screen. Here's Nash with the classic Nash starting off the site. Recovered in time. Bazooka knee. You just never know when all of a sudden Infiltration is going to be coming in.
Oh, okay. There we go. Tokido getting that uppercut.
Air to air
and into the throw. Into another throw. Ooh. Oh, but
he tried to stick out the meaty right into the belly and.
Tokido using some of that.
What an escape! He's away. He came back in. Thought it was time. Anti-air.
A jump in for Infiltration.
That was time.
And he almost has enough meter for a super. He does.
He does. He can take it. He can take it.
Ooh.
That was a gutsy tech.
Oh, and an EX fireball. A clutch EX fireball from Tokido.
Round two. Fight.
Anti-air with the bazooka knee and right back to that spot right there. That spot, it feels like he can control the whole match from right there. He can zone, he can move forward, and all of a sudden he's attacking. He can move even farther backward to a more frustrating spot. It just seems like such a good spot to fight from.
Oh, wow. He's just going to throw out that uppercut right there. Try to stave off a little bit of that Infiltration bridge. Oh, and he gets a counter hit knee into the jab link. And a forward dash into the jump roundhouse.
Saving the meter. Tokido. Oh, okay. Can he get out of there? Will he get out of there?
Oh, he got caught.
Huh. Tokido now hoping for something in the corner.
to throw. Tokido can still do this. Oh, there it is in the super. Is that enough? I don't think that's not quite enough.
Something else.
And the jab hits the V.
Trigger.
I've seen combo videos do that, but I haven't seen it happen in a grand finals at a Capcom premiere event.
Yo, that was some TZW stuff, man.
And Tokido going up two games now.
Yeah, if he can reset
to one,
that'd be a huge for him. What? Yo, I feel like that was like some virtual pressing, like stand S and seeing what happens, right? But it was Ryu stand jab. Tokido in the corner. Really great harassment. Oh wow, lands with the proper button. And you know what? Wasn't working out anymore, so infiltration backing off. But Tokido, it's enough.
It's enough.
That's set point.
Round two. Fight.
Everybody wants the reset. You can hear the crowd coming in. He wanted to get close. The parry!
And you see him with that jab in the middle to get the timing? Wow!
This man is ready.
Tokido is on fire, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, wait, never mind. Oh, he was it was lucky that he got hit out of the air, yeah.
Well, that could have been the set.
Oh, what an air throw by Infiltration. Infiltration will not say die.
Yeah, we have to see a little bit of a change from him here.
Oh, was that in time? It wasn't. Tokido has reset the bracket. We're going to the final set here in Grand Finals. Tokido versus Infiltration.
Tokido, there he is. You see him. Can he do it? Can he qualify for the Capcom Cup? Can he win a premiere? Like you said, the rules are not the same rules as last year. Last year it was if you got second place to somebody who'd already qualified, you were thereby qualified. And in fact, that is how Tokido qualified for Capcom Cup last year.
That's
but
right.
But not anymore. Now you have to outright win, and if you don't, it just doesn't count. So he can do it. He's reset it 3 out of 5 either way to decide the end.
Ooh, ow, that's beefy trades right there. And now Infiltration getting in with the dash. Oh, Tokido gets the jump and he confirms into the hurricane. Wow, great patience from Infiltration to block.
I love Infiltration doing that escape and then immediately take control with stand jab. It's not a damaging option, it's just an I'm doing it. It's my option now.
Tokido is just a tiny chunk away from building up that super. If he can get the hit, he's got the hit! But was that a dizzy? No. Okay, there it is. There it is. Okay, he's got it. And that super is enough to kill, and Tokido now stealing the rounds. He's making all the clutch comebacks. All those matches in loser's bracket, taking it from 0-2 down against Momochi, maybe built up a lot of his confidence.
The start of this round was a jump from Tokido, and there was not a down strong from Nash. And that might have been the first time. And that's a tell. That's a sign. Okay, gets it this time, but not before. That's something Tokido will have paid attention to. Gets the grab. Now what can Infiltration make happen? He's close to taking this. Certainly if he can find the super, it's over.
Oh wow, he just got hit by that.
Yeah, what was he looking for?
Not sure. Okay, he got the jump in. Just getting out of there with a V reversal. But now he has a life deficit. Whoa, that had to have been a fireball that came out. Oh, what a forward dash in the throw. And a parry against the stand rat house. The standard follow-up for all Nash players after that throw is that stand rat house. And Tokido said, I see you, Infiltration. I know what you're going to do. There's the parry. There's my win. Tokido now with the lead over Infiltration.
Oh my god, look at that. Sick replay. Buttons in the mid range. Trying to approach here is Tokido. And I wonder if it's going to be more deliberate mid range. Well, maybe more pressure style from Infiltration.
Oh, he's got the jump in, yep. And I like that he confirms that into the hurricane, not the uppercut, because he gets better positioning and a better pressure to crush counter into the stun! He's going for the safe jump setups. Oh, what a throw tech from Infiltration, but the low strong from Tokido! Everything is going Tokido's way now!
The jump forward at just the right time was not a hit, but it was enough to get him in. And it's starting to seem like this slippery style is not as slippery anymore.
I don't know what it is that Tokido maybe has gotten a read on. But...
okay, I like that a lot, actually. To get the knockdown.
Yeah, and the corner position.
Yeah, and before V-trigger from Nash, sure. Here you go. You know, a big part of the Nash game is escaping. And if you can pressure him before he has a V-reversal, or sorry, V-trigger, great.
Great block from Tokido. And again, just getting that knockdown. He wants to keep the pressure going. Able to punish that whiff knee. Oh, Juicy! Just
again, Infiltration no longer just doing the anti-airs. I mean, we're seeing him escape rather than doing that. I feel like there is a change in his gameplay. It's not just Tokido doing well. I feel like there's some changes in Infil as well.
And watch out, Tokido's got that meter. Oh, Infiltration. Oh, and he's...
Super's ready for Tokido at any moment's notice. He can get through things. He can react. That's right. He'll almost have it. If you, I mean, it's very close.
Yeah.
There it is.
Okay, there it is. Yes.
I'm gonna
blow. Oh, but he just got the jump in over the stand roundhouse. Tokido. He's up 2-0.
Yeah, he is. He is. He's in a great position to take this thing and thereby qualify for Capcom Cup. He has lost twice in premier tournaments to the man he's playing against right now, and it's looking for once like it might go the other way. What will Infiltration's adaptation be? Will it be characters? No, it's Nash! He's gonna run it on Nash. Why not? Thought he might have something else, but no, this has been his go-to, and it remains.
And the crowd chanting Tokido. Always a bridesmaid, but never a bride. He is trying to get himself hitched right now.
I've already noticed a couple of changes. One is, oh my god.
Oh wow,
even max
range confirm and close to stun. Great throw tech.
The movement through, okay. Can he get a punish?
That was supposed to punish that throw tech again. Okay, ooh, but you know, Infiltration's been cleaner than that before. When he's dashed under, he's always anti-aired with the crowd strong on the stand jab, and that time he just missed the timing.
Oh.
And then, just gets a counter hit!
He saves the bar. Is that smart? I don't know.
And he goes for the throw after the fourth. On the fourth time, Tokido match point here at CEO. Can he do this? Or does Infiltration have enough gas in him to make this trek all the way back?
I just want to see some changes out of Infiltration's play, and I don't know where we're going to get to see that. Tokido is harassing him so well. Look at this corner.
He's got the hit! He's got the stun! He's got a full meter! Is this gonna be enough to kill?
He can't kill. Maybe he can kill? No!
Not quite!
Tokido!
And he does it! He does it! He qualifies for Capcom Cup with a perfect! Tokido has done it! He has done it! He's qualified here at CEO with a perfect! And you can see the elation on his face!
What a way to end it. Not only to win, not only to reset the bracket, but with a perfect, what a statement against somebody who in two previous premieres sent him out as number two. They had played in between those two and it was a different result, but in this tournament at the start, Infiltration won 3-1. So for Tokido to make the changes he needed to make on the fly during this tournament, I think that is as impressive as anything can be in Street Fighter.
And you know, the interesting part to me is that he started in the winner's bracket. He lost the Infiltration first round. He had to go through basically the fires of Mordor just to get back to grand finals. And I feel like that trek kind of prepped him for that, because he had the comeback against Momochi. That had to have been a confidence builder. The audience giving Tokido.
I remember last year
when he
first qualified for Capcom Cup, it was by getting second place or third place even. It was something like that. And he wasn't happy with that. He wanted to qualify by winning. He ultimately did that at Canada Cup. But I remember him being very disappointed in himself that he hadn't outright won a premiere. Now he's already done it at CEO. Congrats to Tokido. Number one guy today.
This guy, I mean... man, look at this path that he went. Started it in winner's bracket, lost to Infiltration, got immediately sent to loser's bracket. And he went up against Daigo, then Haitani, and then Infiltration again. Yep. Oh, I'm sorry, Momochi, then Infiltration. He beat the other three gods all in a row, like there.
All right, well, let's go to Alex in the front.
Can I please get the rest of the top eight back into the ring, please? We're going to have our awards ceremony. They're going to bring up somebody to show you something. Did you guys have a good time? This is incredible, guys. One more time. I can't thank you enough. I love this venue, but it's time to go bigger, isn't it? Yeah. Just thank you to all of you. Big thank you to Kenny Omega one more time for coming out this whole weekend. Now for our awards. In seventh place, give it up to Mago. Mago. Mago.
Look at this man. Look at this man.
Elijah is ready.
Mago, thank you.
Give it up for Mago, everybody.
More money from Capcom.
Okay, thank you.
Also, give it up all the way from Japan, Nuki. He's coming up.
Nuki, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, sir. Also, in fifth place, give it up to Japan's Daigo.
Plus more from Twitch.
Also in fifth place, for going through a killer, killer tournament for America. Again, thank you to all the internationals for coming. Give it up to America's own, Florida's own, Knuckledoo.
Knuckledoo, 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 Knuckledoo.
In fourth place, give it up to Haitani. Rawr, rawr, rawr. In third place, give it up to Momochi.
I give you a pay pass.
In second place, we thought he was unbeatable.
We thought he was a bot.
Yeah. We thought he was a robot, but he's still an amazing guy. Give it up to Infiltration.
Everybody, all right, and your CEO 2016 Street Fighter V champion, the Murder Face Tokido. Tokido, 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 Tokido,
Tokido, Tokido, Tokido.
Thank you.
One more time, guys. Give it up to all our players, all our attendees, all our spectators, all our stream viewers, all our amazing staff. Give it up to all of them. Thank you. Thank you very much.
CEO! 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 CEO!
And now, let's have a seat.
Yeah!
I'd like to have one of our favorite people over at Capcom unleash this for you. Can we have Nidel from Capcom? Nidel, please to the stage. I'm sorry. Lord Haunts. First, before I hand it over, I want to say thank you to Nidel. He was one of the first people from Capcom to reach out to me to partner up, making CEO one of the first Capcom Fighter streams, and just being so supportive, man, over the years. Thank you for everything you've done. We appreciate it. I appreciate it. The floor is yours.
Yeah. Shout out to Alex. CEO just gets bigger and better every year. I'm excited to see what you have in store next year. It's going to be awesome. So anyway, I know you guys have been waiting a really long time for this update for Street Fighter V. I know you guys are hungry. You guys are hungry for some content, right? So what do we got? What do we got? We got costumes. We got stages. We got the cinematic story mode. It's super sick. Check it out. We got Ibuki. I know you want to play Ibuki. All right. I don't know if that's enough. I think you guys want more. We feel the exact same way. So I'm happy to announce that Balrog will be playable with this update coming this Friday to Street Fighter V. Roll the trailer. Let's go.
Well then.